beauty.
All right. Yeah, I was going to say, start off with, yes, welcome to a beauty of a stream. Ha ha ha. Yeah, I just spotted that sign and thought, excellent. Right, yeah, so this is probably where the YouTube version will start, if I remember to cut off the start, which sometimes I don't. But yeah, there you go. So, right, let's start off with a dream I had, because why not? I dreamt that there was Yakuza was two-player, and me and Yakobu were playing it, and one of us spotted a locker key on a roof, like a low roof, and we go, well, neither of us can reach it, da-da-da, and then when I stood near you as a character, it said, press X to boost or something. I thought, oh, what's that? And I pressed it, and I grabbed your foot, and it did like a heat action where I threw you onto the roof. And you went, right, well, now I'm up here, what do I do? And I went, well, I don't know, find the locker key, where is it? And I had to go, no, close to the left, no, the left, no, the other left. And I had to guide you, and then you picked it up and had to throw it down to me, and then you went, right, well, this is all well and good, but how do I get down? And I went, well, I don't know, I didn't even know I could get you up there. It's fucking hilarious. It's just like, oh, and then you had to, I had to walk around the building and go, yeah, there's a ladder on the backside. And you go, oh, okay. We had to work out how to get down this building. But yeah, that's the only bit I remember from the dream. It seemed quite fun, though. Oh, dear.
Seems like a quite good good amount of detail.
Yeah, I know. It was a thing. See, the thing is, I don't know how much of that I'm actually remembering from the dream and how much of that I'm willfully filling in the gaps in terms of how I think that dream should have gone. But I remember about 90% of that. Maybe I'm filling in maybe 10%, but... yeah, it's just funny. And there was loads more, but I can't remember any of it properly. Something about one of us went to... you go, oh, I need to do the sub-quest. Oh, I need to have health items for this. Well, I'll start it, and you go to Popo's and get some stuff. Okay, then, and all that. And it was just like we were just working as a team. It was quite fun.
That's cool.
So that's what my dreams are like, anyway. Okay. Oh, and something about there was a mix of... I think my brain mixes features that I've already seen. And it was... oh, what two features did it mix? I'm trying to think. We had to grow plants, I think. And we both had to get tips from people on how to grow plants. It just reminded me seeing that plant in the background. And it was like the growing thing from 7... but yeah. What it was you grew the plants to be weapons or something, and they were like organic weapons, and there was like we grew this really cool thorny vine thing that stuck to people, and yeah, that's all I remember about that, really.
Sega, are you there, Sega?
Yeah. See, all these, see, my brain's coming up with good ideas. Right, okay, so what I did...
studios.
Take notice. Yeah, so that's... I'll delete my two-player dream reminder. This is an interesting thing I read as well. Just a quick thing. So, you know, when I... oh, I don't know if you remember this, but when I started the game, it said, oh, because you have previous Yakuza save data, I got that little... I've not got it on me anymore. I've got that... why haven't I got that equipped? Weird. Oh, that glove thing, by the way. When you grab someone behind and steal money, I don't know how that works, but I'll work it out at some point. Yeah, so we had that little bell thing on us that gave us 3 defense in all 3 categories for having previous save data. I was reading the start of the Yakuza guide thing, and it said, oh, you get this bell, da da da, and all this. And then it said, if you have Fist of the North Star, Lost Paradise, or Judgment save data, you get a gold plate for each of them, apparently. So that's interesting. So I didn't know about that, because obviously I've not played either of them, so I don't have that. But, I mean, it wouldn't have been a huge early game boost, but it would have been nice. Well, it's 200,000 yen early on, so... so that's that. And then... ah, right, yeah. So the thing that I most did off-stream was go through all the sub-stories, and not what they do or where they are or anything, just the names and the numbers. And then made a note of all of them, all the ones we haven't done yet. And there's some in weirdly early chapters that we somehow missed, but... okay, hold on. Different cola today. It's Morrison's cola. It's all right, actually. One of the things it mentioned was, oh, and of course, da-da-da, if you do this with Mack at the top of town... I mean, sorry? And so when you meet people with green arrows like this, you just get generic sort of story shit. Like, yeah, he can't trust either of the politicians, the military base, and all that. So I started to ignore people with arrows. But there's a guy, because there's one over there as well. I think that's another story one. But I think this is Mack, the guy who sends you the revelations and stuff. So I think this is technically a sub-story, even though it's not marked as one. But I'll talk to him and see.
Oh.
Yeah, it is him. There you go. What's crack-a-lacking, Kiryu? Yeah, you have to voice him like Barrett from Final Fantasy VII. Because it's Japanese and he's black, so you have to voice him like that. Not much, Mack. You ever get that perfect shot you were looking for? Oh, maybe it's another revelation, actually. I never thought of that. Can't say I did. I've been scouring every last corner of this town. All I've come up with is big fat fistful of nothing. I think that's a film. Sorry to hear that. It's the worst Western film of all time. Big fat fistfuls of nothing. Oh, hold on. The window's gone weird. Oh, the stream's not crashing, is it?
No.
Okay. No, normally the stream started being... The screen started being weird. It usually does that before it crashes, so... sorry to hear that. I guess you can't expect opportunity just to fall in your lap, though. Let me know if I can help. Appreciate that's a heaven and high above, Kiryu. Hey, by the way, you mentioned some place you wanted to take me last time. I don't actually remember that, but fair enough. Think you can elaborate?
Oh,
snap, Kiryu. I thought he was going to punch me then. This whole thing just up and slipped my mind. You bet I'll elaborate. Elaborate and listen. No. It's the hippest, swankiest, rough and tumblest joint this side of the Sea of Japan, and yours truly just so happens to have a buddy bringing home the bacon over there. Is it the Colosseum? Because we've already been there. Dum-ba-dum-dum-dum-dum. Yeah, it's the Yakobu laying down the beats, as it were. Oh, that might have been another one. Sorry, this is triggering different parts of that dream again. I think it was like, it was some mini-game, and... One of us had to control a deck and one of us had to dance or something. It was a bit like that disco thing. And I remember us going in and going, oh, this is a cool setup. And then someone went, yeah, it's a bit like disco. And I went, oh, fuck off. I can't be arsed with that shit again. But yeah, it was like a two-player mini game or something. And then there was, I think one of the games was... not Dance Dance Revolution, but a game like that where we had to compete against each other or something, and we both did so crap that it didn't think we were human or something. It was just like, are you human? And it was like, okay, I know I didn't do very well. I looked over at your score and it was a bit higher than mine, and I thought, okay, we both did shit on that then, apparently, because we're both not good at that game. It's probably the memory of us both being crap at that disco thing.
Yeah, are you human? And then you have to solve one of those puzzles
to get back
into the game.
They go, oh dear, the floor has fallen apart. You need to do one of those annoying slidey puzzles that you get where all the bits are fixed into a grid and it's like a nine square thing. Yeah. God. Yeah,
which
imagine that if you
have to... is a cat.
Yeah. Oh, it's a kitty cat. yeah, so Mack has access to wherever the hell we're going.
I'm your not a robot.
Oh, I've just thought who this might be. I'm not going to say who I think it is in case I get it right or wrong, but if I get it wrong or right, I'll let you know truthfully. You're saying he works there too? Oh, you're saying he works there, right?
Yes.
What was that?
Yes.
Dang Skippy. I almost forgot what it's called. Purgatory. Kind of scary sounding, huh? Yeah, it is the Colosseum. Did you just say purgatory? I love Kiryu's little... Ugh. Oh god, he's got the same voice as fucking, what's his name? Hey, boy! Yeah, Bacchus. Look, I know the name kind of gives you the heebie-jeebies, but don't doubt good old Mack. I haven't breathed the sweetest sip of air since I first stepped foot in that place. Anyway, I get the feeling my perfect shot's just around the corner. And by around the corner, I of course mean through some weird door in a bathroom stall. Well, Kiryu, gotta run. I'll tell my purgatory power you're coming, so stop by if you can muster up the courage. Yeah, I don't know, I just get the feeling I know who this buddy's gonna be, but we'll see. Wait, Mack. He's... something. Just the blank stare of, yeah, sure, okay. I guess I could swing by purgatory when I have the time. Which is now. Also, fuck you, Crane. I made you cry. I remember clipping that and calling it breaking Yakobu because you couldn't stop laughing. And I didn't even know why until you got your breath back to tell me. Ah, dear. All right.
It was a painful day.
Painful day for the people of certain countries. there it is. Oh, do you know what? Actually, in my dream, it might have been this building. So why would we have needed a ladder? Maybe it was taller in my dream, I don't know. But yeah, I remember me going, no, it's on the left corner, and you going over to the other corner and going, no, my left down here. Yeah. And I was going, there it is, and you had to throw it to me, and then we had to try and work out a way for you to get down.
That's fun. Right, yes, the right one.
Yes, the right direction. Go the right direction. Which one? Yes, that one. It's like what that bloody, what's it called, Who's On First sketch from Abbott and Costello. Kiryu, just the guy I wanted to see. And conveniently, one of the only dudes who even knows about this place. Yeah, I have been here before, once or twice. Yeah, here I am.
Okay.
Well, without further ado, it's time you get acquainted with that friend I was telling you about. Alright, okay, let's see if I was right or not. And I'll be honest if I was. Come on out here, Akuda. Ah, it's not. Yeah, I thought it was going to be Gary Holmes. Hey, scare you. Yeah, I see. What was it? Sudden death or suds on breasts? But then he got it wrong another time and said, yeah. No, what was it? Sudden death or baby death? And he just went, yeah, I see your Japanese is about as good as it ever was. Okay, he's, nice suit. Hey, Mac, this the guy? Hold on a second. You're one of Majima's men, aren't you? Is he? Okay, fair enough. Kiryu. Mac said he's new. What was that? Yeah, you have to do that, what I call turtleneck, where you lean your head back slightly and, like, it pulls the muscles forward. Mac said his new pal is a tough cookie, but I never would have guessed it'd be you. Anyway, the name's Akuda, which is funny because we had Akada here before, and we had that mini game with the wrestlers in it that got me really excited from Kiwami 2. That one where you had to defend boxes against various enemies in a tower defense type of thing. I wonder if that'll ever come back. I supervise the construction around here. Though, as you can see, there hasn't been much of that going on of late. Oh, true. Hold up. You two know each other? Mac. This guy. He's the You can stop right there. Oh, of course, sir. Yes, he's the The drink of a popos. Yes, that's it. The bathing beauty. Yes, I think that covered that quite well, Smithers. Man, I just knew two would get along. I just knew you two would get along like peas in a pod. Heck, you're practically wearing the same threads, too. I did notice that. Although his is stripy, but still. Huh. Always the optimists. So, what are we doing here? The whole place looks kinda empty.
Yes.
Empty. Empty. Yes, empty. It's almost like it's an empty lot. No, not again! sorry, choking on my own humour there. Maybe for now, bring it out, Akuda. Imagine if he goes, yeah, and then there's just like a split second black screen, then when it cuts back, there's a huge, like a some sort of massive merry-go-round or something. Aye, aye, Mac. Training formation A. Move out! Okay. Yes, sir. Okay. Where the fuck did all that shit come from? Okay. So, Kiryu. Oh, this looks like that mini game with what's her name? Miss Tatsu, where you had to smash boxes and it's a rotating dummies with guns. Reminds me of that. So, Kiryu, is it everything you ever hoped and dreamed? I don't know what to say. It's incredible. All for Mack and his perfect shot. And my boys here have been working their routines just to get the setup just right. This is going to be something ridiculous that doesn't work and is funny because of the way it doesn't work. That's my guess, anyway. I had no idea you'd be lending a hand with this too, Kiryu. It hit me like a flash of lightning to the skull when I saw the way you run, Kiryu. It was like... it's a dramatic noise. It was like, I don't know why, but it felt like you were going to be my one-way ticket to that perfect shot I've been after. So, you mind running some more? You know, get the camera juices flowing. Ugh. I guess it couldn't hurt. In this town, you never know when you might need to chase someone down. Okay. Oh, do you know what I'm thinking? Is this going to be heat action we can use in chases? That'd be cool. Huh. Am I just going to be running by myself, though? Well, there's the ten. That's the 10-bit there. There's the 10 billion yen question. Could I have the 10 billion yen if I get it right? The thick and thin of it is, Kiryu, I'm going to be running away, and I want you to catch me. Catch me! You sure? I'm pretty fast, you know. No problem at all. I used to live out among a herd of gazelle on the African plains. My being here is proof enough that I outran every lion I ever came across. Yeah, talk about stereotypes. Jesus fucking Christ. Okay. I outran the gazelles of the Serengeti. It's like going, yeah, we get it, Japanese people. He's black. We get it. Okay. That's an interesting way to train. Anyway, sure. I'll help you get this perfect shot. You will? Thank you. Oh, thank you, Kiryu. Just give me a holler when you want to run. If you beat me, I'll teach you some of the most esoteric secrets I learned in my world travels. Yeah, this makes me think this is going to be more another person we can earn heat actions from. This is pretty cool. Huh, can't think of a better reward. Looking forward to it, Mack. Okay. Just got a trophy called Path of the Warrior. Encounter all the masters. Okay, well that pretty much guarantees that he's a personal... Where'd all the stuff go? Okay. Sure, why not? Oh, Kiryu. Hey, Akuda. Think I'm going to need to train again, if you don't mind. Oh, no problem. Construction's not slated to start. Well, technically ever, so we're in the clear. I'm sure the boss will be thrilled to lend you a hand, too. I have to say, I never thought Mac's friend would end up being a Majima family henchman. You two make an interesting pair. Well, you'd be surprised how often we hear that. Yeah. Want to know how we first met? It was at a smoky bar in a back alley of Kamurocho. Let me guess, was it, Earth Angel, maybe? I've been arguing with the old ball and chain back home, so I was sulking hard. Went the only place I knew I could get some peace and quiet. But then some guy started going off about a foreigner who spilled a drink on him. Clearly this arsehole was just trying to pick a fight with the out-of-towner. I don't know if it was my mood, or because it was my turf, but I felt obligated to help the poor foreigner out. And as you might have guessed, that foreigner was Mack. We got to talking right after that. He spent the rest of the night regaling me with tall tales of all the places around the world he's gone searching for the perfect shot. All the places around the world, rather. I guess we just hit it off, you know? Makes sense, too. I've got a pretty big travel bug myself. That's incredible. Well, long story short, we always get together and toss a few back when Mac's in town. I mentioned he means baseballs, I don't know. And now I'm going to do whatever it takes to get him that shot at the... Oh, he's been after... There. God. Get... Breathe. Right. And now I'm going to do whatever it takes to get him, to help him get that shot he's been after all these years. God, I'd be an awful voice actor. It's like the words are in front of you. Yeah, I know. I've read it 3 times. I've still got the bloody thing wrong. And apart from Kiryu, who we know is a good voice actor, with his ending line. He was in that, what was it, that gay anime thing or whatever the hell he was being. Yeah. Anyway, feel free to come by whenever you want. Thanks. Kuda.
The Yaoi game.
That's it. I was trying to think of the word. Yeah. What was it? In South Park, they went, Yaoi translates to Baizu Lever. or something like that. It was just boy's love in a weird accent. Howdy there, Kiryu. What flavour of Mac you looking for today? Not the correct spelling of flavour, but fine. Oh.
The Big Mac.
The Big Mac, please. Hit me up if you want to learn the details of how this all works. I'm not reading that. Test.
Yeah, it can't cut out.
Okay.
For a second.
Yeah. So bad. my controller just completely crapped out. Well, battery wise, anyway. So yeah, I just thought, what the hell? It went quiet. Okay. Yeah. So sorry about that. Yeah. Okay. So read the rules. Yeah, I was saying about I'm not going to read the word. Well, that I'll just read the word details. So, what are the rules? Clear max trainings to earn skills that will help you in future chases. Yeah. So these are actual. They'll give me, I don't know, like better tackles, or maybe I can, I don't know, I can't imagine what they'd give me to help me with running, other than run faster, the enemy runs slower, you can slow down time, maybe, just weird shit like that, I'm just guessing, but they will help you in future chases. This will also unlock the next training, beat the records to get special items. Training B has no records, so you will get an item just for clearing the course. Huh. Well, let's do training A, then. A would usually be first, then B. C would usually follow. Okie dokie. We're ready to groove, Akuda. Just a second. Bang, bang, bang. We're supposed to believe you put that up in that amount of time. Okay. You pumped for this, Kiryu? Well, you better be. I've got a big honking present for you if you can smash the record. Good luck. Okay, well, go on.
Punch reminds me of Todd Unctuous.
Todd Unctuous! Yeah. Oh shit, I thought that was the corner. So the record is what, like 25 seconds, I think I saw. Shit. Oh, tits. Yeah, I fucked it now. I reckon this is one of these things, if you've run into anything once, you can't get the best record or whatever. Why is he... Is X not the shoulder barge button? I thought it was. Well, I'll obviously have to do this again anyway, so... Oh, I was pressing the jump button rather than the fucking... Yeah, okay, can I start this again? Oh, interestingly, if you pause, it says return to title. So the game does have the capacity to return you to the title screen, it just doesn't let you from a load screen. That's annoying. There you go, I got him. Although I've got, like, no stamina left now, so... Yeah. Pant. I'll have another go at that because I was pressing the wrong button because I'm an idiot. Too bad, so sad. Looks like Mac came out on top. Damn it. I'll get you next time, Gadget. Next time. Okay. I mean, I assume we have to do A to unlock B because it did say that, so... Yeah, that's the trouble. Don't go for two in a row because it never works. Could have had another one there. Got to try and cut him off on the corners and then hit him like that. Nice. I almost got two in a row there, so it is kind of possible. Alright. You really burned my rubber out there, Kiryu. Wow. Hey, Mr. Green Fox. Coming in hot. Welcome. Hope you are doing well, etc. I knew if anyone was going to run me down, it was you. One last technique for you. Got this special from an Irish Wiccan in the Emerald Fields. Or was it that hippie in California? You could smell that peacemobile coming from a mile away. Let me tell you. It literally says. that was just inviting me to say that. Anyway, breathe in extra deep and keep that air on lockdown up in your lungs. Channel your inner hippie, you know? And that's all you got to do. Ow. Oh, just got a pain in my head. Chase. I don't know why I read that as Chas. Your chase gauge has increased. This will let you continue chase sequences for longer than before. Right, yeah, I was hoping more stamina would be a thing we could get. Why are you training with Eddie Murphy? I don't know, motherfucker. Oh, no, wait, that's Samuel Jackson, isn't it? I don't know. There's Kiryu on a running track. Right, okay.
Take a seat, young Skywalker.
Let me see. Okay. Pop on by whenever you want to run again. Okay. So,
My impression sounded more like Lawrence Fishburne.
What was it, that thing Lois in Family Guy? It's like, oh, they gave me free drinks once because they thought I was Lawrence Fishburne.
Francine.
That's it. Oh, yeah, in American Dad.
Yeah.
Okay, let's see. All right. So, if you do that under 25, do you get something else? Completion. I'm just looking at the thing to see if it's worth trying again, see if I can get under 25. Wide spot, yeah, okay. Okay, that's interesting. Yeah, so completion, increased chase gauge, record time 25. Okay, so I think the first time you do it, you get some sort of upgrade to your chase. And then the second time you do it, you get an item. And some of those items sound interesting. So we'll do the training first, and then we might go through and get the items or something, depending on if we want to. We're flipping the script in this one. Instead of you coming after me, I'll be biting at your ankles. Escape to win. Oh, this is interesting. So we're actually running away from him. From this angle, Kiryu seems to have a really tiny head, says Green Fox. Does he? Oh, maybe because his hair.
His body's, like, really wide.
Yeah, that's a hangover from it being a PS3 game. Everyone's bodies were wide. So I've got to run away from him. Okay, is it the same course? Because I'm definitely going to fail at this the first time if it's a different course, because I won't know where to go. We're ready to groove, Okuda. Just a second. Okay, it's a different course. Right, so is it going to be linear, or is it like a big open space? Because I imagine it'd have to be linear for this to work. You pumped for this, Kiryu? Well, you better be. I'll give you a beautiful little present if you beat me out there. Good luck. So, I just have to run away from him as long as possible, I guess. Keep running until your pursuer is too tired to keep chasing you. If the pursuer's energy gauge runs out before yours does, you win. Your pursuer's energy gauge will gradually decrease during the chase. Okay. Yeah, this doesn't seem linear. Fuck off! Jump that. Shit, dead end! See what I mean? I don't know, the shape of the course yet. Nah, done. I'd have to learn a route, and then, yeah. The Mack attack is back in action. Damn, I lost. Yep, you sure did. Too bad, says the air, okay. Same text, right, okay. Have another go at that. What's C? C has got timing as well. Oh, okay. So this one doesn't really have a time, you just do it until it works, basically. Trouble is, I don't know when he's sprinting, so... Because that would be good to know, but... Okay. I think jumping over things is probably a good idea. Because I think that gets you further ahead. Actually, yeah, I can... Oh, I know where he is on the thing. I just realised, if I look at the bottom of the thing... Should have been looking at that all along, really. Run out of stamina. Come on. Oh, he's really, really low on stamina. Okay. Although I'm not getting out of this fucking hole. Come on. Hey, there we go. Done it. Right, okay. Pant, pant. I'm out of juice. Looks like my goose is cooked. Naughty goose. I have to play that at some point. What was that little squeak? Was that him running out of energy? Him
that
squeezing
was,
the last of the juice.
Attempt at a goose. I'm sorry.
Yakobu, it's like something from the Olympics. Yakobu there attempting the goose. It's a bit like the high jump, but more squeaky and more bells being stolen.
Also, don't mention the war.
Don't mention the war. I mentioned it once, but I think I got away with it all right.
Attempting the goose.
Oh, yes, of course, yes. You started it. No, I didn't. Yes, you did. You invaded Poland. that's fucking classic, that line. You knew you were going to run me down. It was you. I guess it's time I teach you my signature Mack tackle. Well, do you want me to show you my Mack tackle? We're here alone in a building site. Sure, why not? Some people try to combine the two, call it a mackle, but I don't talk to those people anymore. Coming from the guy who said, I'll tell you the deets. I mean, I agree with you on the mackle thing, that's awful, but, yeah, okay. Anyways, this will boost the oomph you can put into your tackle. You'll be dragging guys down like you were born to do it. Your tackle power has increased. Wow. This will make your tackles hit harder when you strike an opponent. I'm so childish. Oh, and I got a nice little present for you too. Bow whenever.
Sure, he's talking about fishing.
Yeah. Go. Lovely tackle. Do you want to see my tackle box? I can see it from here. Your trousers are too tight. That's like a bottom joke. It's like, have you? What was it? Have you got cornflakes? No, no. It's just the way my trousers hang. I've got a nice little present for you. Bow and everything. You can't carry anymore. Okay. Collapsible hammer. Is that a thing? Okay, why not? Okay, let's dump away those thief gloves because I don't know how they work. Maybe we'll work that out another time.
Interesting concept.
Yeah, a collapsible hammer. Huh.
If it's like a telescopic sledgehammer, especially.
The thing is, you would think, though, if you're going to be smashing stuff really, really fucking hard, you wouldn't want something that could possibly collapse. No. This has got a really strong locking mechanism when you fully extended it. But, yeah, it'd have to be bloody strong. Also, that would make part of the handle hollow, which would sort of... Isn't that the point of hammers, that the handle isn't hollow? I don't know. I'm not sure that would work. I don't know. You'd have to ask someone who uses hammers a lot, I suppose.
Well, unless it sort of works as both a giant mallet and a sledgehammer.
Oh, true. Yeah, I honestly don't know enough about hammers to know if that would work as a concept or not, or indeed if they exist in real life.
Yes.
They exist here, damn it, and that's enough. Pop on by when you want to run again. Okay, training C. This one's got timings on it. The timings are higher, which makes me think it's more difficult. This one's got curves for days, man. I'll warn you, catching me is going to take every last drop you've got in the tank. Okay, sure. So there's going to be lots of corners. Okay, honking big present, yes. Okay. Oh, nice! Shit. Yeah, I think jumping over things actually puts you further ahead. I didn't realise that until now.
Ah.
Hey, Greybeard. Oh, I didn't think I could get him there again. Oh, shit, the wrong button. Fuck. Although he is very, very low on his stamina bar, so I might do this. Not very quickly, but... Nice, got him. First time, not very quickly, as I say, but... I don't know what getting the top score gets you other than the item, but maybe it's just for completion, in which case I don't really care, but because I'm never going to complete all the mini games anyway, because I can't play some of them, so if I knew you were going to run me down, it was you, yeah. Let me hit you with another breathing technique. I think I learned this one from a guru out in the forests of India. Was it that witch doctor in Tanzania? Eh, doesn't matter. I love how he can't remember. Anyway, all you've got to do is breathe even deeper than last time. Fill those lungs till it feels like they're going to pop. Then you're golden. Your chase gauge has increased. This will let you continue chase sequences for longer than before. Right, so it's a long. It's another boost to the... okay. Mm-hmm. Okay, was that all the training, or...? No, apparently not. Ultimate training. You ready to see my final form? This isn't it. No, okay, that joke's not going to work because he already said it. You're not ready to see Mack's final form. Green Fox says, who are you? Okie dokie. Are we ready to groove? Just a second. Okay, this looks like the first course again. Maybe it's just the first course again, but he's a lot faster or something. Who knows? Let's find out in a minute. Well, you better be. I've got a big honking present for you if you can smash the record. Okay. Oh, shit. No, that's the wrong button as well. I've completely fucked it already. Maybe not. Yeah, I can get him after a jump. And indeed there. Nice. I almost ran ahead of him there. Oh shit. Ah. Yeah, you can't jump both of those, I don't think, because there's a slight delay in the jump. Ah, too soon. I tried to throw a bin in front of me. Bastard. Oh, I've run out of sprint. Alright, there we go. I could have had him way earlier than this, but if I'd not screwed up on that little bit in the middle. Shit. Tried to take the corner too tight. Come on. I lost my fucking lead there. Tell us it's taking ages because the music's changed. I don't think I've ever heard this bit of this music before. Yeah, we both jumped one. I don't think you can jump both of those. I keep going the wrong way on that bloody corner. Fuck. Shit. I've run out of stamina now. God, I had a massive lead before, and now look at our fucking health bars. We're about the same. Fuck it. Yeah, screwed that up completely. so annoying. I had like five times the amount of health he did and still lost. Close though. Under 40 seconds. So you'd have to do that pretty perfectly, I reckon, to get under 40. So yeah, if getting the top record in this is just for completion, then I don't really care. But I mean, if it's for really, really good items, then I might look into it. Because that might be something I practice off stream, maybe. Because it seems like it'll be something that'll take me loads and loads of goes. I ran ahead of him there slightly. Huh. And again, nice. What? Oh, come on, I jumped that. Fuck off. Took that too wide. What? Look, I was right on top of him. I don't know, whatever. So you're telling me that this would have been possible 10 seconds ago? How the hell you do it that quickly? I don't know. Fuck. You actually almost did it last time. Yeah, I know. In about 3 minutes. The record. Oh, there you go. Got him. Nice. I reckon you're supposed to be able to do that in under a single lap. I don't know how the hell you do it, but... If it's a case of you just need to do it, I can do it. But if we need to do it under a certain time, there's no chance. No, I mean in the short time. What, in under 40 seconds? I don't know. I didn't notice. Maybe because I was one hit away from getting him and then it just took me a minute and a half to lose. I don't know. Anyway, you know, I get this fancy breathing technique I teach you. Do you know what I'm thinking? I think you have to learn... You just elongated the last hit. Yeah, exactly. I think you have to learn all these techniques and then try doing them again. Because now I've got all these upgrades, I can then do the races again but make them easier. So, I don't know. Hey, Neo. Apologise for being late. No, that's fine. We only started... all we've done so far really is this. So all you've missed is the racing stuff. I got this fancy breathing technique I could teach you. I think I learned it from the monks in Tibet. Or maybe it was the shamans in the Amazon. Whatever. Anyway. And my dreams about two-player Yakuza that I talked about. But there you go. They were quite fun. You want to... re-listen to the start of the stream if you want to hear my Yakuza 2 player dream. Breathe in real deep. Imagine you're a fleshy balloon. Well, don't we all? Full of nothing but clean mountain air, and then you're done. Your chase gauge is increased. This will let you continue chase sequences for longer than before. Gravity says I bought console number 22. A Japanese fat PS2, transparent blue with matching controller and cables. Nice. We are just running with Eddie Murphy at the moment, yeah. You're heavily invested in Lost Judgment. Good, I'm glad to hear it's good. I'll play that sometime. Okay, so, Max training. We got the collapsible hammer. Do we just need to do them a second time to get the items, or do we actually have to beat the record? I'll try the first one again and see if... Because if we've just got to do it, then I can just run through these in about a minute. Because we don't have to listen to any of the text, it's all the same anyway. It's a slow burner at first, but it gets you good halfway through. Yeah, this one was a very slow start, but yeah. It's been alright. I'm not too crazy about the actual fighting portion of the game, which ironically is the main bit, but still...
Just sort of get lost a bit in the middle.
And do you have a judgment about that?
Yes.
Without the E. I just got it. There you go. It's lost in the middle. Yeah, because the E gets lost and it's in the middle of the word judgment.
Da-da-da-da-da-da. It was there all along.
It was there all along. It was me, Austin. Oh, you son of a bitch.
Also, hello, Neil.
Yeah, hello, Nia. I got both Judgment games. Haven't got around to playing them yet. Yes, if I look to my right, I can see Judgment and Lost Judgment next to Ishin and Yakuza Like a Dragon. Because all the other games, all the other Yakuza games I've got, I bought digitally because they were super cheap. So there you go.
I think it's on sale on Steam now. Lost Judgment.
I think most of them are on sale at any time. It's like an MFI sale. It's like any given point in history, there's usually been a sale on sofa somewhere.
Yeah. Not another sale that DFS had that.
This is going really well. Suspiciously well. Shit. Nah, fucked it. Oh, I thought I could get him on the corner. Don't fuck me over now, you bitch. Nice. Okay, I think I probably could have had him a couple of seconds earlier, but... right, so we'll see if that gets us the item. Because we obviously didn't get under 25. Ah, shit. No, okay, you've got to get first place to be... No, there's no chance then. So, the other items are... okay, I definitely got the collapsible hammer, but apparently, because there's no time for that, you get that, whatever you do, as long as you complete it. The record for the first one is under 25 seconds. You get a radiant blade, which is some sort of sword, I guess. Let me...
Could be Gen 5.
The weapons, yeah. It's got 5 blades instead of 9, or whatever. Right, okay, let's have a look. Find, yeah, radiant blade. Oh, maybe it's a accessory. Hold on, radiant blade. No, it could be a material. No, what the fuck is it then? Radiant blade. I don't know. It's not searchable on any of the lists. Hold on, yeah, because of 3. Weapons, right. Find blade. I don't know, it's literally not on here. So fuck knows what that is then. Right, okay. What were the other items? Collapsible hammer, Majima's order form. That sounds interesting. Alright, what the hell's that? Okay, that is a... Oh, right, that's like a catalogue for building weapons from. Okay. So, that would allow you to build the Patriarch's driver, which is a golf club, and the Patriarch's bat, which is obviously a baseball bat. Okay, that's that then. We're not missing out too much there. And then the other thing is Mack's Talisman. And what's that? Find... Probably an accessory by the sounds of things. Mack's Talisman. Reduces heat lost when you get hit. Yeah, okay. Okay, so other than the Majima's order form would be good if we were going for 100%, which we aren't, and we're not going to need those weapons anyway. The collapsible hammer we got. Mack's Talisman, whatever. I've got no idea what the Radiant Blade is, though, so if anyone happens to know, let me know. But, yeah, that seemed to be Mack's training. But I'm glad to have got those upgrades to the chase shit, at least. I might have a go at those off stream, because I get the feeling that's one of those things that I do for an hour while I'm listening to a podcast. So, yeah, I'll let you know how that goes, though. But we've sampled all those. Anyway, why did I run around that way? I like running over this bit just because it changes his footprints for a little while. Ah. Sandy. Alright, okay. Sandy balls. that's a real place. I don't know why. Right, okay. There's Matt. Okay, so we've done the Mack thing. Right. Okay. So... Only at night. Okay. bounce. Okay. All right. So, bear in mind, when I now say sub-stories as an option of something we can do, there are some that aren't marked on the map, which I will have to slightly possibly look up. Some of them are marked, some of them aren't, because I think some of them are a bit like the Mack thing, where they're just sort of people or whatever, and we talk to them and that starts something. But so we either do sub-stories, hostessing, or probably not main story for now, just because I think that moves us to another city. We kind of want to do some stuff here before we go. So, yeah, it's basically a choice between sub-story and hostessing. What's that? I think this is just two people talking. Who do you think will be the next president of the Citizens Liberal Party? Suzuki, no question. He's got a real good image thanks to that Okinawa resort deal he's got promoting. On the other hand, Tamiyama's been pushing that military expansion bill, even though nobody in Japan really wants that kind of thing. What if someone were to launch a nuclear missile at Japan? I heard this new BMD system can protect us. Unless it's a big shield, I doubt it. That's all way too theoretical for me. Who'd even want to attack us anyway? At least the result would bring some concrete results. Well, so that's why you're betting on Suzuki, huh? Maybe you're right. Yeah, so that's the argument between building the military base or building the leaving it as it is, basically, the resort thing, so our orphanage can stay where it is. Right, okay. Okay. So, any thoughts from people in chat or whatever about sub-story or hostessing? I'll move towards... I think, well, in the vague direction of both anyway, because I've got to walk some. Neo says sub-stories. What's that? Oh, that's just the club. Okay. Where is the nearest sub-story? Probably... Well, now I've walked a bit. Probably the one down... Oh! Or Hitman stuff. That's the other thing. I was trying to think. I knew there was something else. Because we're just coming up on the Hitman headquarters down here. So, yeah.
There's a lot of NPCs that look like Jay from in between us.
Yeah, all right.
But I go sub-stories.
Okay. Yeah, I was going to say, but you talk to these women, you have to ask them questions. Yeah, of course, the only question I ask them is, what old do you want it in first? That was genuinely the line. I think we're going to have to fight this guy. Or not. Okay. There's a woman with some things. Woman handing out flyers, that is indeed what she is. If only she had that heat action that we unlocked where she could throw them at people and put them in their hands. That thing with the tissues, that was hilarious. 6 years of my brother's life has been stolen away because of false charges. I'm asking for any help if I can get to save his life from unjust imprisonment. It can't be her. Read the truth. Hey. Oh, Kiryu. What are you doing standing around here? And who's that? What's she handing out? I don't know, she's just thrusting it back and forth by the looks of things. I think they're... Hey, you over there. That was an interesting run cycle for that short amount of space. I knew it. It is you. You're that journalist. Look what happened to my brother, thanks to you. What happened? I never intended for that to, is it just me, or does his face look painted on at the moment? That's so weird. Journalists only care about themselves. Do you have any idea what horrible things happen to the people you write about? Oh, I've just realised, is this the guy that took the picture of me with that guy's dad behind us? From another quest? It might be. My brother didn't kill anybody. Run. Sounds like you two have quite the past. Yeah. What happened exactly? Maybe we should talk someplace else. Sure. 6 years ago.
Smileburger.
Yeah, exactly. Yeah. Should we go and meet somewhere? Oh, let me guess. Smileburger. Nope, somewhere else. Share play will end in 5 minutes. I'll start another one. Hold on. I don't have to do that for a while. Everyone else just wait a moment. The Muzak will carry you through. Excuse me. Oh yeah, Neo said we'll have to buy the Yakuza Remastered Collection again. Is that because you sold it, I assume? 6 years ago, there was a murder here at Cafe Alps. Here? The suspect was a man named Yuichi Akechi. And, oh, there's the noise of something important. That woman you just saw is his older sister, Nozomi Akechi. Yuichi Akechi. I investigated the story and wrote an article implicating Yuichi-san as the murderer. And this was the article that woman was talking about? That's right. Yuichi has consistently denied any involvement in the crime since his arrest. Well, maybe he's right. I don't know. To be honest, even though I wrote the article, I wasn't completely convinced he'd done the deed. Well, yeah, you're a dick. I didn't even want to publish it. Oh, he was forced to. I didn't want to make him out to be the criminal before we had all the facts. Let me guess, it got published anyway? I was the only person in the department who even considered Yuichi might be innocent. I was only just getting my start as a journalist, so I had to go along with what my department wanted to do. Neo bought it on release day, sold it, and now I want to buy it again. Okay, fair enough. Yeah, I don't know how, for my Yakuza collection. Yeah, boy. Yeah, I find that, I mean, maybe there's a reason for this. Well, I know what the reason was partly, but there's no reason not to talk about it at all. But someone on the Discord once posted a picture of every version of Yakuza they had, and it was like the size of a carpet, and they never talk about Yakuza, which I always thought was a bit odd, but whatever. I dug much too far into Yuichi's life for my investigation. I interviewed his relatives, even people in his neighbourhood. Because of my reporting, people started labelling the Akechi family as the murderer family. They were forced to move. Poor Nozomi got bullied a lot at school too. That kind of stuff happens, but I guess she does have a pretty good reason to resent you. Ever since Yuichi was declared guilty, I can't stop thinking about him. Should I have written that article? Were the charges against him false? False? You mean there's a chance Yuichi didn't do it? What makes you think that? I actually used to have a part-time job here a long time ago. Is that so? These cameras are going to get slowly closer and closer to it up their noses. Is that so? I worked with Yuichi. We talked all the time, and I got to know him pretty well. I just don't think he's a murderer. Huh? After that story got published, I swear I'd never repeat the same mistake. I've become an honest journalist who only reports the truth. Yeah, sure, okay. Good luck with that. Are you really just going to let this go, then? What? You still have doubts about the case, right? Yes. Then shouldn't you be trying to discover the truth? We'll have to do this. We'll have to go detective mode. So far, all you have is Yakuza 7 and 1 and 2 for PS2. Nice. Technically, I own 1 and 2 for PS2 as well. They're just on a hard drive inside the PS2. But still. You know what? You're right. I think I gave up after that article came out. But you're absolutely right. I think I'll look into it one more time. How should I go about it, though? I mean, it's been 6 years since the murder happened. I guess you got to start by talking to everyone involved in the case. Phoenix Wright, objection! Sure, but what?
Hello?
Could you help me, Kiryu? Yeah, here we go. Huh? If I don't find out the truth, I'll regret writing that article for the rest of my life. I don't want to look at that guy's nose. He's got a weird nose. You want me to look into that old murder with you? Imagine after all that. I don't have that kind of time. Goodbye. Yeah, all right, I'll do it.
Yeah.
Thank you. Ugh. So tell me more about the crime Yuichi Akechi was arrested for 6 years ago. 100%. Yeah, exactly. Alright, here's the rundown. Right, now, given that this is autoplay, you can autoplay this like it's scrolling through. I imagine this is going to be important information, so I don't know how much of this we need or have to write down, but we'll see. Oh, God. Yeah, this is proper. Oh, voices. Right. Oh, late at night. I was going to say, if this happened during the day, surely everyone saw it, but okay. Right, okay. Hopefully there's some sort of recap for this later, because there's no way I'm going to remember this. Right, Kinoshita found it first.
この店のウェイターだった明智雄一さんは清掃作業の途中、店の裏のゴミ捨て場に行こうとしました。
Right. So he was outside, okay.
その途中、ロッカールームの前を通りかかった時、雄一さんはわずかにドアが開いていることに気づきました。
Sorry, I thought you'd finished speaking. The door was ajar. Oh well, that's why it didn't work. It should have been a door.
その時、ロッカールームの中では店長の小田さんとウェイトレスの宇佐美さんが。
I like the little explanation mark that came up over his head like Metal Gear Solid. He saw them in a compromising position, so he peeked through the hole and enjoyed himself.
その宇佐美という女性は雄一さんの恋人でした。雄一さんは恋人の浮気現場を目撃してしまったんです。
So Asami's his girlfriend and Oda was with her, not the one from Yakuza 0, because he's not alive.
Okay.
So they got into a fight, that's kind of expected.
Alright.
Yuichi-san がなかなか戻ってこないことを不審に思って... So he was away. Yeah. He was away for a while, so Kinoshita went to check on him.
すると木下さんは店の裏口から出ていく雄一さんの姿を見かけました。
Okay, back exit. And then he
木下さんはロッカールームのドアが開いていることに気づき、中を覗いてみたところ。
Right, so
頭から血を流して死んでいる店長の小田さんの姿が。
I am noticing something missing already, but we'll carry on because the thing might turn up, so.
Okay,
so whoever it was smashed him over the head with an ashtray. I'm surprised people haven't died more in this game given the amount of shit we've hit people in the head with, but yeah, okay. That's the gist of it. Right, if that's the gist of it, where did the woman go? Because he went into... He saw him at it, he went in and fought with the bloke, and then when the other guy came out to check on him, he saw him leaving, and the guy was dead. But where was the woman? That's made me suspicious of her straight away. That's the gist of it. I see. You really do know a lot about this case. But from what you say, Yuichi's motive seems pretty clear. Seems obvious he killed the guy his girlfriend was cheating on him with. Yeah, but where did she go? That's the point. I'm sure that's what the police thought too. When they discovered more evidence later, they decided to arrest Yuichi. They found more evidence? Oh, I should give you this. It's the ashtray with the blood on it. Yeah, okay, thanks. What is it? The notebook I used to collect information about the case. Please take a look at it. Okay, this is cool. So hopefully this notebook gets us all that information in it so we don't have to remember it. We can just check on it. Neo says he wrote notes about this. Yeah, I probably would have done if I'd done this off stream. If they're going to give us all the information anyway. Plus the fact that I think I could probably look the information up if I needed a recap, so we'll see. Please take a look at it. You might see something I missed. Yeah, so there, maybe there's more in the notes than he told us about. You got to Wakazu's notebook. Hey. Access Wakazu's notebook by pausing, navigating to the item screen and pressing R1. Yeah, that's to go to valuables. Select Wakazu's notebook to look at information on people related to the case. New information may be added to the notebook as the investigation unfolds. Yeah, so this is very Phoenix Wrighty. Like, items update with new information when things happen or you find out new stuff or whatever. Check the notebook frequently to find hints as to where to go next. If you get stuck, take another look at the notebook and think about where you might need to go to find the next clue. Got it. Mini judgment, yeah. Okay, so can we talk to him again? Did you find out anything? No, nothing conclusive yet. Okay. My notebook should have information. Yeah, okay. Yeah, Yeah, got it. Right, okay. So, notebook. I just guessed it was that one because it looked like a notebook. Oh, wow, it gives us a little thingy, like a... what's it called? Like in the people that are related to a screen. I can't think what it's called. Right, okay, so... okay. Cheating with Oda. Oda's the victim. Okay. Lead detective. I mean, I would have thought the first port of call is to talk to the lead detective. Because we haven't really got any information at the moment, so I'm guessing that. Lead detective for Division 1. Led murder investigating from the start. His initial suspicion of Akechi led to arrest. Unparalleled drinker found in the bars of Kamurocho almost all nights of the week. Dislikes coffee. Right, okay, so... that makes me think possibly we can't finish this now if he's going to be... he can only be found in bars at night. So that might be a place to start. The suspect is in prison. Maybe we could talk to him. Waiter at Cafe Alps. Was in relationship with... okay, past locker room while closing store. In fact, actually, yeah, that's a point. Could we go and look at the locker room and all that? That might be a place to start. Fingerprints found on murder weapon. Yeah, but if it was an ashtray from the bar, then that's not that weird that his fingerprints would be on it. Convicted of murder. Right, okay. Maybe his sister wouldn't have been there, so I don't know why that would be interesting. Distributes flyers to help. Yeah, that's just the woman that was giving out the flyers, so I don't think she's important right now. Obviously, we can't talk to Oda, because he's dead. I thought that said Call of Duty. It's COD, cause of death. Yeah, fair enough. Call of Duty. He played Call of Duty and now he's got Bloodhead Force trauma. Yeah, that sounds about right. Now, she's the most interesting one because she's missing from the setup of where they set up the crime. Had already ended shift on day of murder but stayed in store. Yeah, that seems weird. Okay, yeah, I'm suspecting that she might have done it for now, but we'll see. He witnessed the scene of the crime. He might be good to talk to. Was cleaning with Akechi at time of murder. Discovered Oda's body after witnessing Akechi fleeing the scene. That he called the police, right? So either of these two, they were still in the bar, so maybe they'd have heard something, but was closing register at the time. Not present on the day of the murder. Okay, so the fact that he wasn't present on the day of murder means one of two things. Either he did it, in which case he came in on an off day so he wouldn't be on the register to have been there, or he's literally not important at all because he wasn't there. So, do any of those people still work here? Because that might be somewhere to start, unless there's somewhere else here. No. I wonder if this would just... maybe... I don't really want anything, but okay. So, the only thing I've got is that that guy's in bars at night, but it's not night time, so Am I right in thinking that I literally can't get any further in this at the moment? I'm not going to read any further ahead, but I just want to check if I'm right about that. Because if I'm not, if I'm right, then I'll just go and do something else. But so this is Murder at Cafe Alps, Chapter 9. Murder at Cafe Alps. We'll hand you his notebook. Yeah, okay. The only lead you'll get is that the detective in charge goes to bars at night. So I got that right. Yeah, okay. I think that's literally all we can do for now. Neo suggests getting into a fight outside and coming back in. Might be a good idea. I'll try that. If not, then I think we literally have to just wait until much later. So technically, we shouldn't really have started this now, because I'm going to have forgotten all this by the time we get back to it. But, maybe talk to her. I never thought of that. Yeah, I genuinely didn't even think of this. She's still out here. Maybe talk to her. Weren't you the guy who was with that reporter? What do you want? He told me about the case. I'm helping him look for information to try and prove your brother's innocence. Huh? What are you talking about?
I'll be back in a minute.
Mm-hmm. Crap. Ugh. Sorry, I had to swallow a lump of air. He feels responsible, so we're looking for a way to help your brother. Oh, really? Well, you're too late. My brother's been in prison for 6 years. Do you think you can just waltz up to me and pretend to care now? Just leave me alone. Okay, so no then. I'll try getting into a fight and going back in, but I think we're probably stuck for now. In terms of it not being night time yet. So, yeah. Where would be the... It's the funny thing, isn't it? You want to run away from fights all the time, then when you actually want one, you can't find one. Oh, there's one. I'll try going in somewhere else as well, because that might refresh something. I don't know. We'll see. Green Fox says, stupid thing I decided to look at. I randomly just came you checked to see if I don't know what that bit's supposed to mean, but you checked if the Blockbuster website was still online. It is, just with a message saying we are working on rewinding your movie. That sounds about right. Okay. Let's go to Smileberg, because that's where everyone goes. We actually do need to fill up our health again, so it might be worth doing that. Here. I'll have the Giga meal, please. Oh, almost. Oh, yeah, exactly. I'll get a drink or chips or something. Drink's cheaper. By like 20 yen. There you go. Hey. Alright. Cafe Alps. No, that's pronto. Wait. No, hold on, Cafe Alps is down this way, isn't it? Oh, great. See what I mean? I was looking for a fight, and now we've got into another one, even though we don't need it.
Oh,
great. Oh, fucking stun. It's so annoying. Strangely smelly 5 grand. Nice. Nope, still went the wrong way. Okay.
No more.
Could have eaten here, I suppose. Oh well, whatever. Yum yum. 69. Yeah, so I think that's about it for now. Okay. So, because I'm right near it, I might go and do a hitman thing. Got room to go around the back rather than around the front, because I always make that mistake. I'm going to take on that one that I think might get us stuck, but I'll see. Could have checked that off stream, I suppose. Forgot. Right. Silver bullet. Is that the one we skipped or not? Huh. Maybe I'm thinking of something else. I don't know. Alright. Kurana. Armed with guns. This is the one I skipped. It says he appears every night, which makes me think we can't do this one now. So I might do this one, because then, if we're stuck, we've only got that one left, and we won't be stuck on anything, if you know what I mean. So, let's do this one. Armed with blade weapon sighted near a Millennium Tower. Okay. Alright. Because if it's near Millennium Tower, that's handy, because the help guy is right near there as well. Yeah, it's funny. If we go, hey, do you know where he is? He goes, no, I think he's behind me, though, because the marker for him's right behind the guy that gives you help. Yeah, I can literally see there's the guy that we're looking for, and there's the guy that will help you find him. Or if he goes, I've got no idea where he is. Sorry, I haven't seen him at all. Yeah, because from here, you can't see him. Oh, hey, Kiri, you come here a lot now, don't you? Now that you mention it. How come you're always here playing? Well, the Millennium Tower is kind of like the symbol of Kamurocho. A lot of tourists come to see it too. They even stop to listen to my songs. I guess I'm part of the local colour, not how you spell colour. People from around here, though, they don't have any interest in street musicians like me. He's right. First time visitor to Kamurocho will probably want to visit the Millennium Tower. Yeah, so there you go. So there's your clue, I guess. What gets me is they give you... Oh, I thought he had a gold face for a second. He's looking up. That's really weird. Yeah, I've made that mistake before of thinking the underside of people's necks are their face. Okay. Nippon is awesome, man. That's Japan in Japanese. Look at that building. Wonder how many stories it is. Ichi-ni-san. Hey, what are you trying to accomplish here? I'm looking at one of Kamurocho's famous landmarks, the Millennium Tower. Can I help you with something? You're the Reaper Lorenz, aren't you? Sure am. And you're Kazuma Kiryu. Wait, how do you know my name? It's like, because you're the most famous person in this entire town, I imagine. It confuses me more when we meet people who don't know who we are, but okay. I came here to learn about the Tojo clan. You're their fourth boss, right? Yeah, for a couple of minutes. You're just the guy I've been looking for. I was hoping I could talk to someone in the know. What about? I'm looking for information on the Tojo clan. Only someone like you would know about, if you know what I mean. Nudge, nudge, wink, wink. I'm not in the business anymore. If you want inside information, ask someone else. That's not gonna cut it. Chances like this don't come along every day, you know. If you don't want to talk, I'll just have to make you. Okay. Is this the first time we've ever fought in front of the Millennium Tower? I think it might be, actually, because you don't normally get fights up here. Huh. Are there any, yeah, because I don't remember ever fighting up here before, and there's a really small space to fight in, so... Ugh. What if we can tiger drop that? Well, I couldn't that time, but... We can counter knee it, I know that much. Whoa, what was that? Ugh. Never said I was good at this game. Give it a damn good go, though. Yeah. Try and catch him in, and then, yeah. Yeah, and then you can counter that with a counter it, and then throw him. Yeah, what? Throws aren't doing much damage, actually. I mean, they will add up, but... Okay. Ugh. I had a prime opportunity to attack him then and completely screwed it up. Actually... Yeah, we never tried that sword. Hold on, he's got a sword, so I don't see it as cheating, really. Yeah, a cutlass. Oh. Finishing time. Yeah, okay. I hope we get the third one of those at some point, because there's only two finishers. I mean, they're cool, but, you know. Is he still going to live, or...? Yeah, okay. Dropkick! You're not half bad. No wonder the Tojo clan made you one of their bosses. I'm not with the Tojo clan anymore, so you can stop calling me one of their bosses. Former boss, I think you'll find. Oh, nice. Thank you for the 10 bits, Neo. Thank you very much. Much appreciated, dear. That will go towards, I don't know, something. But yes, thank you very much. Still, I'm surprised to see you wielding a katana. Yes, I mean, I was wielding a sword as well, but that's besides the point. When it comes to slicing and dicing, you can't do any better than a Japanese katana. I thought I'd see a lot of them when I came to Japan, but there don't seem to be many around. They're not that easy to get a hold of. No, I was going to say, in modern-day Japan, you'd have to go to a specialist store, I imagine. And even then, they probably wouldn't let you buy it unless you had some sort of certificate or something, because, I mean, they probably sell them not sharp. I mean, for display, you can have them not sharp, it doesn't matter, but, you know, unless you're actually going to use it, which I don't imagine they want people to do, then, yeah. I guess not. I guess it looks like I blew my chance to learn about the Tojo clan. Did you join the Reapers just so you could learn about the Tojo clan? That's right. Really? Couldn't have just gone to a library. You're right, I heard they were fighting the Tojo clan. Oh, yeah, he joined the Reapers, so he could learn about them because they were fighting them. Thought I could learn some cool shit. And they say Kamurocho is the best place to get information. That's why I came here. Should have talked to that guy out front. He gives me all sorts of information. What were you going to do with the information? I wasn't trying to start any trouble. I was just interested in the world of the Japanese underground. I see. Oh, we should send him to the Colosseum. He'd love it. Well, come with me to the HLA for now. Maybe you can learn a few things about the Tojo clan there. If your interest in the clan is just mere curiosity, then there's the place for you. Hey, that sounds great. I owe you one. Beep. Great work, Kiryu. I'll take it from here. Ibuki's waiting for you at headquarters. I'll accompany you there. Okay, let me see. I've just got to very quickly check something. Okay. Started.com/finish. Okay. Just wanted to make a note next to that murder at Cafe Alps thing. Because I forgot to earlier. Glad you're okay. Seems Lorenz really was just curious about the Tojo clan. Even general information about the clan, like the number of members and the names of the leaders, seemed to really make him happy. Oh, see, those things seem to really make him happy. Yeah, I mean, it's probably quite easy to look up. It's not exactly private information, is it? On the other hand, when I asked him about the Reapers, he didn't know anything about the top leaders. Same as the other hitmen. Yeah, this is going to be a thing where they're being controlled by, like, the Amon clan or some shit like that. Kiryu, well done. Here is your reward. We appreciate your hard work. 130,000 yen. Please come back again. Excuse me. We're really counting on you. Good, good. Alright, okay. I'm wondering at some point will these ever be filled? I mean, I know it was a hotel at some point, but I'm just thinking some of the more dangerous people we pick up might go in these at some point. Can we go in here yet? No, okay. I'm wondering if, yeah, the archive room only unlocks when you've done all the hitmen missions or something, and that's how you find out who runs the place or whatever. But I don't know, so we'll see. Yep, he certainly did come and pick us up. That guy's still working there, good. Crap, I pissed up my soda. Oh no. Alright, okay, we might as well do the other one while we're here. Just check, because I don't know if this is going to, like that quest that we started at Cafe Alps, and we can't start it until night time. Because it mentions this guy hangs around at night, so I don't know if that means we can or can't do it now. I mean, I'd look it up if I could, but I don't know if I can, so. I suppose I could look up the hitmen. There's probably a menu of them somewhere. Hitmen missions, there we go. What one is it? Kuranai the Silver Bullet.
Back.
Hey. Kuranai hangs out at Theatre Square. It doesn't mention if it's nighttime or not, though. So I honestly don't know. Yeah, the only thing you miss while you're away is because we did one of these hitmen missions, and there was a guy called Lorenz, hanging out in front of Millennium Tower, and he had a sword with him, and he joined the Reapers because he was just, I want to know more about the Tojo clan. Hey, you're one of their leaders, and we had a fight, and then we won, and then we thought, oh, he wants to, like, find out so he can crash the Tojo clan or take it down or something. He went, no, I'm just really interested. And he was, when he came back, he was talking to this guy here, and he said, I told him how many members there were and the names of the leaders, and he seemed really happy. He just wanted to know about the Tojo clan, literally. That's all he wanted. So, as it turns out, it wasn't as dangerous as we thought. Okay, and we had a bit of a sword fight, because I pulled out my sword, and, Yeah, exactly, Neo. It was just funny. It was just like, he's looking for information so he can put them away or whatever. No, he literally just wants the information. It's like, what he wants is Wikipedia. That's what he wants. Tojo clan. Yeah, he wants the Yakuza wiki, which there is one. I don't know. When did Wikipedia start? That must have been quite early in the internet's life, mustn't it? Don't know. Probably wasn't big until, like, the mid-2000s, though. This is 2007. I imagine Wikipedia would have had to have been around at least by then. But yeah, I don't know how big or how well it was run or whatever by then. So, okay. Well, let's accept this one, assuming that we can do it now, because it mentions nighttime. So we'll see. If it marks it on the map, then we can. Yes, we can. It's marked on the map. Right, okay. Let's go do this one, and then we'll do more sub-stories. Because as it turns out, that one we started, we can't do, so... I did also check if getting into a fight or going into another shop would refresh it, but it just doesn't. So, yeah, I think we just need to wait till night time and then check some bars. Check bars that don't serve coffee, because that's the only clue we've got, really. But, yeah. Wait. Oh. No, up. Okay. Run behind him, avoid the fight. Yeah. Hey, it's NY hot dog again. New York hot dog style hot dog and coffee. I imagine just reading that in a Japanese way. Just don't read it with any punctuation in your voice. New York hot dog, New York style hot dog and coffee. Those are the things we sell here, and mixed together as well. Okay, this looks like the guy here. Are we being chased still? No. Okay.
Almost sounds like something they would do, just blend a hot dog and put it into a coffee.
Yeah, just like checkmate, yeah, when Homer drops the sausage into Bart's milk. Just reminded me of that. Checkmate, always one step ahead. Huh? What do you want, you old geezer? Didn't anybody ever teach you any manners? You're the Reaper Kuronai, aren't you? Damn straight. Kuronai, the silver bullet. But how the hell do you know about me? I'm with the HLA, Hot Lesbian Action Line. I want you to come with me. So you're from the HLA, are you? Yeah, that's right. Well, well, well. How convenient. I'm going to laugh slowly back and forth like one of those little drinking birds.
How convenient.
How convenient. Yes, I'm working with a foreign mafia, the Chinese. I was hoping we'd find some Chinese people just so I had an excuse to say that, but I don't think we will. It just so happened... Look older. Right, that's ridiculous, Carl. That's the most convoluted, ridiculous, racist piece of information we've ever played on air. Play it again. I fucking love that. Oh, God. And that thing the other day, you listened to that movie review thing, that's hilarious. That's one of the features in the early days where Ricky reviewed a film as lazily as possible, and it was hilarious. So, it was, what was it, the, what was that film where it was all in black and white, but the jacket was red or something? I can't think what it's called now, but, yeah, it's one of those sort of really long, epic, sort of sad films. He said, I watched that, it was alright.
Schindler's List,
yeah. He went, it was set in the olden days because it was in black and white. Didn't like that, but fair enough. There was a thing where just the coat was red. Might have been a printing error or something, I don't know. And he's just saying stuff like that. And he was going, the Nazis didn't win in the end, so... And then Steve went, was that the end of the sentence? Yep. Something like that. And he went, what did you think of the film? Was it too long at 3.5 hours? I fast-forwarded through some of it. What'd you rate it? 8 out of 10? it's just the stupidest feature they ever did, but I found it hilarious. Oh dear. Anyway, yeah, and then they said to Carl, would you watch the movie on that recommendation? I'm surprised they managed to fit all that in 3.5 hours. Brilliant. Piss off.
Come on, mouse, stay still.
Speed. There you go. Yakobu has upgraded the heat action to close down moderators slightly faster. Ta-da! Like that thing we got from Mack to run faster. Yeah, there was a... just to fill in anyone who... What was that, sorry?
I've slowed down over the years. I used to be able to just go click.
Click!
Dead.
Yeah. Jump on it like a gazelle. Yeah, for anyone who doesn't know what's going on because you're only hearing the audio of this, there was one of those, we've got a promotion for you, fucking spam bot twat. So yeah. So Yakobu has dealt with that as speedily as possible. And he's very good at it as well. So, it just so happens I've got something interesting to show you. Follow me. You really think I'm going to fall for this? Come on, man. I swear it's really sweet. Just follow me. Follow me. Flawless okay.
Victory.
Stupid new emote on Twitch. I don't know. I quite like that. It's kind of small, but then all emotes are. Yeah, colour-wise, I'm not crazy about the colours it is. But, I mean, the fire bit at the bottom looks kind of cool. Ideally, the Mortal Kombat logo should be darker anyway, but, yeah. This ought to be a good place. So, where's this thing you were talking about? Imagine if one of the Yakuza characters went, you've got to come with me to this parking lot, this park, to show you something really incredible. It turns out they've just done a really big poo in those toilets in the background. No, I was just so impressed by it. It was ridiculous. I've got to show it to someone. And then there's a Yakuza member standing outside. Who's this guy? Oh, I paid him to look after it so no one would flush it in the meantime. I imagine Yakuza doing something like that. I'm the poo protector, and then we've got a tiger drop his head into a big pile of shit. I imagine him doing that. We've tickled Yakobu again. Looks
all
like
these,
they did.
All these references are going into a cartoon. In my head.
Yeah. The Yakuza cartoon. There's like heat. Oh, wasn't there a heat action before in another game where we could, what was it? In Kiwami 2, when we helped people out and they would throw you free weapons during a fight. And one of them was the guy that worked in this very toilet and he threw you a plunger with a little bit of poo on it and you could sucker it onto their face. I remember that now. Looks like they did not remember to rework this guy's model. Yeah, the one-off NPCs have worked on probably slightly less than Kiryu and people who are going to be in this for hours at a time, but you do tend to see the same NPCs over and over again, but still. So where's this thing you were talking about? Heh. Perfect. No, that's... Again, I think that's supposed to be his voice, like, because he laughed when that came up, but it's got Kiryu's name above it. I don't think this is Kiryu saying it. Heh. Perfect. Because why would Kiryu say that? Yeah, as much as I suspected. Yep. What do you say? Fascinating, right? Are these guys Reapers too? I'm going to do that speedy heat action if I can, because there's enough of them. It's my favourite heat action for them from the last couple of streams. No, I'm the only one. These guys are just here to help me. Help me give you a good pummeling, that is. What do you hope to accomplish by doing that? Yeah, and then, yeah, the leader says what Neo's put in chat there. You better watch hard. what do you hope to accomplish by doing that? Don't you get it? We're taking you hostage. Then we're going to crush the HLA. I knew someone would be coming to see if I leaked some info about myself. You walked straight into my trap. Too bad for you, dickhead. I see. It's definitely a very clever trap. Too bad it's not going to work. Dramatic zoom. Get a load of this, Joker. Why so serious, etc. I don't know, I've not seen the film, I just know the quote.
Yes.
I guess we'll just see about that, huh? Yes, yes we will.
Why so serious?
I only know quotes by men that speak like this. Oh, you bitch. Okay, we've got to fight him, because otherwise we're going to run out... Ah, piss off, you dick. You get stun-locked into being shot.
Yeah, knowingly, he killed himself because he was too deep into the lure of the Joker, because he's a method actor, or was.
Yes, of course. Can I not block bullets? I doubt it. I think I'm going to have to abandon the idea of doing that heat action and just beat all the minions first. In fact, the minions may drop their guns. This is not going well, but... Oh, grab someone, for fuck's sake. No, that was stupid. Yeah, I was thinking, if I hold a weapon, I can block shots. Right, there we go.
Yeah, supposedly Jack Nicholson almost went mad as well playing the Joker.
Because of, yeah, serious method acting. That can happen. Oh, I threw the gun at him and that weakened him enough to hit a finisher. Brilliant. Oh, there was no R2 build-up. Huh. I picked this one just because we did the last one in the last fight. And there we go. That guy on the floor, is he part of the fight? No, okay. Oh, stick. Oh, I wish they wouldn't fucking block so much, seriously, come on. Fucking hell, come on! Screw it, I'll just throw him, fuck it. Whatever. I don't know, I genuinely don't know if you can counter bullets with the Tiger Drop, I doubt it though. Gun finisher, thank you very much, Neo, for the clip. Give me a sec. Okay, there we go. Alright. What the hell? Sorry I had to do that. Now start talking about the Reapers. I want details. But I don't know anything. I sure as hell don't know any of the details you're looking for. I don't buy that. You better start talking. You better start talking. Oh, he did the wavy farts thing. If anyone caught that. I'm at the very bottom of the heap. I don't even know who the boss is, I swear. Look, I got kicked out of my family for missing a mark. Okay, I get it, yeah. And then some guy I asked met me to join, so I did. That's it. This guy you met wasn't the boss? No. Someone else is in charge. I don't even know the name of the guy who recruited me. Yeah, I was going to say that might be a start. He's been talking up a storm, but he's not giving me any real info. Guess that means he probably is just an underling, just like he says. I better turn him over to Ibuki now. Put him in one of the cells, then he'll talk. Great work, Kiryu. I'll take it from here. Ibuki's waiting for you at headquarters. I'll accompany you there. Yep, so you sure will. Oh, and Neo gave me 10 bits while you were away, I think, as well. Yeah, I think that was while you were away. And I thanked him for it, and there we go. Great work. I'm glad you're okay. We ask Kuranai all kinds of questions, but it seems he really doesn't know that much about the Reapers. The Reapers are an organization that probably has a lot of rank-and-file members like him. Yeah, I imagine that would probably be the case. Especially if they want to take down the Tojo clan. They'd have to have a lot of people. To get to the guys at the very top, we're going to have to catch people in leadership positions. Kiryu, well done. Oh, excuse me. Well done. Here is your reward. We appreciate your hard work. Ding. Come back again. We're really counting on you. So does that now unlock more, or let's find out. Oh, it does. Okay. I'm thinking that this is one of these things that we can only finish in the final chapter of the game, because again, just to reiterate what my suspicion is, that the leader is probably something to do with Amon, and that's how you get to fight Amon. But normally it's finishing all the sub stories, so maybe not. Don't know. Hold up with hostages. Okay. Yeah, we can do these later though, because we've done a couple now. So I just want to kind of spread out the things we're doing, so we don't end up with loads of one thing all at once. See, that was my only concern with the. I'm not saying we should do it now, but I'm just stating my thought that I was having earlier. The only trouble with the hostess stuff is that it takes so long. I do enjoy it, but there are. Four left, I think, and I think if we left it... fucking hell. If we left it too long, I think we're going to have entire streams of nothing but that at the end, because that'll be the only thing we've got left to do. So, I don't know. I'll have to look into it and see if there is four left. I think I read that. Well, there's at least three. So we've got a whole other club to do. And then I think one unlocks because you've done all the rest of them. Or something. I think I read that at some point. Ah, you. Oh, I didn't realize how fucking low on health I was. Jesus. Yeah, let's pop one of those just in case, just to be safe. Oh, there are four of them. Hold on. Yes, come on, come on. You know what I want to do. Oh, it's surrounded, isn't it? Hold on. Come on, why isn't it working? Do I have to run at them? I can't remember. I think I have to be running, yeah. It's not coming up. Maybe it's a red heat action. Oh, there's only three of them left now anyway, so it doesn't matter. Oh, well, I tried it anyway. You saw me try it. Oh, it's a red heat action. Yeah, that'll be why then. Dunk. That bit of the song for Random Encounters is really good. The trouble is, it doesn't happen until about a minute in, which means you rarely hear it. A pleasant 20 grand. Nice. Mr. Green Fox says, gotta go now, lads and old fucks. Have a good one. Okay. Have a good time, Mr. Green Fox. See you on Discord. And, yes, have fun. And I got a notification for something. Oh, it's a batch tool thing, whatever that is. What's this? Oh, it's because you banned someone earlier. Yeah, that's fine. Yeah, it was that thing. I was thinking, when did someone ban someone? Yeah. Right, so, okay, choices, right. Sub-stories... we could do more Hitman stuff, I guess. Hitman stuff, sub-stories, hostess stuff, or... there was something else. Can't think what it was. I don't know, it'll probably come to me, but yeah. Let me know, anyone, if you want to make a choice. I'll have to go this way anyway.
Because shopping at Popo's.
Popo's. There's a Popo's. Did you say go try shopping at Popo's?
Yes.
Okay, fine. I will. Was that just for fun or because you read something?
No, it's just for fun.
Fair enough.
Not very much fun, but still.
Still? Club sandwich. Our club sandwich is sure to fill you up. It's even good cold. Why would you eat a club sandwich hot? That's interesting. Steamed bun, please. Oh, no, we've only got room for one thing. Let's buy some dog food and eat that. Okay.
CC lemon, I've drunk that.
CC lemon. Packed with real lemons. It's both refreshing and healthy. Is it like lemonade, or is it like lemon water?
Like lemonade.
Oh, nice. That sounds pretty good. Let's have some. Packed with 70 lemons worth of vitamin C.
Supposedly.
Look how much health that filled up. It barely even moved. Mind you, it is a drink, I suppose. Let's go with... tonkotsu's always good.
How much was it in the menu?
Oh, what, CC lemon?
Yeah.
Or I'll have to eat the thing first because I can't open the menu without eating it. Well, that filled up quite a lot, actually. CC lemon. 147 yen.
Yeah. So it's gone up in price.
Yeah. From in this game.
Yeah,
because this is, what, 2007 prices, I guess.
I think it's, 156 now.
Hmm.
Unless that's before tax.
Oh, maybe. Although that is all they charge you, so who knows. If it costs a lot more, we can blame Majima, because as we know, he came up with Japanese taxation.
Hmm.
From that time when he came up with it. Righty, then. Pimp slap on the right. Approaching, docking. Pimp slap. Thank you. Imagine we got mentioned. So, yeah. Funnily enough, actually, I stood on a manhole cover as you posted that emote with the manhole cover. Weirdly, there's a fight there, but he hasn't activated. Because that's really strange. I don't know. Oh, maybe he wasn't a fight. Huh, weird.
No, it's coming for you.
No. Oh, yeah, he stood still for so long, I thought it was going to be a fight, but he just grabbed that woman's hand and toddled off. Okay, whatever. Right, yeah, so... one thing as well, and I must mention this in case people aren't choosing it because of a certain reason. With the hostess stuff, you know how it takes so long to do? We don't have to do it all in one go. So if someone chose it, that wouldn't be solidly hours of stuff. It would just be as long as we want to do it for, and then we can come back and do the rest next time. So, either that, or sub-stories, or Hitman stuff. And I need to do another share play.
I choose him.
Hold on a minute. I'll ask you again what you said in a sec. I actually had to pause during one fight because you said something and I legitimately couldn't hear you over the punching noise. It was so loud. Okay. Right, yeah, sorry, what did you choose? I genuinely didn't hear you.
Hitman.
Hitman, okay. Brett the Hitman Hard it is. Bow, 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 bow. Do, do. Oh, I've gone around the wrong bloody side again. That's not suspicious at all. Go away. So there's a guy in a pink... Oh, shit, he needs to fight. Run. That was a close call, baby. Okay, Zen, the Black Hyena. We're getting into 120,000 yen now. Hold up with hostages has several henchmen hiding in a building on Park Avenue in Kamurocho. Your target is Zen, the Black Hyena. He has taken members of the HLA hostage in a building on Park Boulevard. Zen demands that the HLA disband and release the Reapers in our custody. He will stoop to the lowest levels to accomplish his goals, even cheating and trickery, hence his nickname. Okay. Not sure what connection that has, but fine. The hostages' lives are in danger. Please rescue them. Close call. Thank you, Neo. That was quite funny, actually. No! Excuse me. All I've had to eat all day is half a massive pasta bacon cola, so... Yeah. Kind of noisy at the moment in terms of body stuff. Okay. All right. Oh, did it say where he was? Oh, I said it in a building on Park Boulevard, so... Oh, yeah, it marks it anyway. But on the way, it's the hint guy, so we'll go talk to him anyway, just because we can. This guy's got what I call host hair. When you see the hosts, whenever they show the male host in this game, they've all got that hair. Iron Prey! Whoa, what the hell happened there? Whoa! Oh, okay. I thought that had gone flying, he picked it up.
There's an iron train, is there? Also,
Yabuda! Iron Prey! Charge it up! The problem is, once you've started that combo, you can't really stop it. Or at least not that I know of, anyway. Ah. Pick up a tray, will you, you cheating bastard? A beauteous? Is that a word? A beauteous 3 grand. I don't know if I know that word. I mean, obviously I can guess what it means, but... Beauteous. Huh. sort of beauty, having beauty, I guess. But I just don't know if that... Is that a common word? I've never heard that before. At least I don't think so, anyway. Beauticious, maybe, but... Oh, hey, Kiryu. I got something to tell you. Man came bell on his way back from the bathhouse. Said there was all these shady guys on Park Boulevard and they were up to something. Maybe this guy was dizzy from staying in the bath too long or something, but he couldn't tell me what exactly happened. But nothing out of the ordinary for this city, I guess. Yeah, nothing's out of the ordinary for this city, trust me. Sounds like something went down somewhere around the bathhouse on Park Boulevard. Maybe it has something to do with the Hitman Zen. I should check it out. Alright. One accessory I do want to get at some point is that megaphone thing that apparently makes Kiryu's voice louder, because I don't know if it actually does anything other than just make him louder, which would just be amusing to me, to be honest. Right, yeah, up and round. Okay. Do we need healing? Not really. I was going to say I'll go around the other way otherwise, because I can visit the restaurant on the way around there. The bathhouse, is that Aroma Inn? I guess this might be the bathhouse, I don't know. Doesn't look like one. Oh, it could be this actually. This looks more like it. Yeah, possibly. And therefore, there they are. Yeah, okay. So leaving the bathhouse is next door. Right, okay. I don't know if they didn't put a marker on the map, if I'd even know where they meant, though. They went, oh, it's outside that really famous bathhouse in this town. What, one that we've never been to or been told about. Hmm. Also, table tennis?
Yes.
That'd be a good mini-game in this at some point. I say that, it'd probably have awful controls, though, so maybe not. Is a guy named Zen here?
That's just reminding me that Rockstar made a table tennis game for some reason.
Did they?
Yeah.
Huh. Was that a... Oh, I was going to say, was it a Japanese-only thing? But they're not a Japanese company, are they?
No.
It sounds like something that you would find on the PS2, like in a Tennis Table Extreme or whatever, and it's like some game you've never heard of, and it's like an RPG with table tennis.
Yeah, like a 360 game, I think.
Huh. Okay, hold on. Table Tennis.
I think it might just be called Table Tennis as well.
360. By Rockstar Table Tennis. Huh. Yeah. Genuinely never heard of that. That's interesting. Weird. It sounds like something Rockstar would do, but then put it in some bar in GTA or something, and it not be its own game. But, yeah, interesting. Huh? What do you want? Says portly guard. I'm with the HLA. Now, release those hostages. No way. What is the HLA doing here? If you thought taking hostages would stop us from coming after you, then you're dumber than I thought. We're freeing those hostages, even if it means beating some sense into you first. Hey, go report this to Zen. So he is inside then, thanks for letting us know. Got it. Who do you think you are? Some kind of superhero or something? You must be getting senile in your old age. Once again, we're not that old, but fair enough. He looks older than I do. After a good ass-kicking, you can join your friends as another hostage. Uh-huh. Sure. I was hoping we'd fight inside, which I think after we've beaten these two, we may well do, but we'll see. Cone! Grab the fucking flag, then. Right, okay. Dunk. Nice. Neo says Yakuza logic. Yeah, true. Nice. Tiger drop. Finish him off. I saw him going for a punch. I thought, if I can drop this flag quickly enough, I can just about get it in. What the hell? I'm not wasting any more time on you. Step aside. Is it going to... Let's guess which one of the three different offices it's going to be. Huh. Oh. Okay, this isn't one of the three we're thinking of, but we have seen this place before.
Looks like a show home.
Yeah, it really does. Like, here's what the flooring will look like in your new Japanese home. There was some quest before where I think we had to rescue someone from a group, and I think it was here. So, yeah. Tiger Drop Finisher. Thank you, Neo. That's another clip. Good, good. Right, okay. Zen-san, that's the guy. You Zen, then. Hand over the hostages. Because I think I remember using the TV as a weapon, but I might be remembering that wrong. I never expected anyone to come barging in here. Well, whatever. Now that you're here, I guess there's no point in keeping these hostages here. What do you mean? Hey, guys, come keep this guy company while I deal with these hostages. Show him just how hospitable we are. If only you'd listened to me, you could have walked away intact. It's going to take more than this to keep me back. What was that? I said, you must be crazy if you think these weaklings have what it takes to take me on.
I said that rabbits eat lettuce.
Oh, well, that's true. Yeah. Mrs. What the fuck's her name? I keep thinking Miss Crabtree, is that right?
I think so, yeah.
Yeah, I think, yeah. The bus driver in the early South Parks, anyway. Oh, you stupid bitch. What was that? I said I've got an itch. Oh, well, you better scratch it then. No, Crabapple was, I was thinking that as well. That's the woman from The Simpsons, though. That's what I had in my head, first of all, when I was trying to get rid of it to try and remember the actual name. But yeah, it's the woman with the little bird that lives in her hair. Yeah. That never moves or says anything, but yeah. I'll clear them all out before you so much as touch those hostages. Hey, asshole. Who are you calling weak, huh? You lot. Oh, the hostage has got a glowing light round him, which makes me think... Yeah, is he helping us? TV? Oh, I've actually got Zen with this. That's kind of cool because he needs to do more damage. Mike? What? Hold on. I may have leant on the wire. Oh, okay. Alright, okay. As long as you can hear me, that's fine. If I ever cut off, just let me know and I'll try and fix it. I broke your table. Bin. Oh, hold on. Something's going on. Oh, finish up. For some reason, he's got loads of health left. I think it's just because I did a certain amount of damage during the fight. I don't know what triggered that, to be honest, but... Huh.
I think for is there anything... do about three separate R2 buttons.
Yeah, it's weird. There's definitely a third heat action you can do, though. I just need to unlock it first, but I don't know what I need to do that, so maybe I'll look that up. Because having
so you can take it as fast as possible.
Oh, shit, the hostage is dying, I just realised. Should have been keeping an eye on him, really. I thought he was just helping me in the fight. I didn't realise he could actually... Well, I mean, obviously he can, but... Oh, his knife went through his hand for a second there. Damn, what kind of monster are you? Game's over. Give it up. Turn the console off right now. The mission is a failure. Cut the power. No, okay, solid. Take your hostages and get the fuck out of here. Did you forget? You're coming with me too.
You better get out.
You better get out. Yeah. He goes, I want to get out of this place as quickly as possible. Well, if we had a heat action where we could take you out to the balcony and throw you off, trust me, I would have done it. Son of a bitch. Why does it always fucking end like this for me? Does that mean you've been pulling these kind of dirty tricks since your days in the Yakuza? If that's the case, I'm not surprised they kicked you out. Nah, shut the fuck up. I don't need no sermon from you. I can't blame them for not wanting to put up with that, with antics like these. I wouldn't want to have anything to do with you either. Ooh, bitch. Son of a bitch. Yeah, exactly. You can go call off at the HLA. Beep. Great work, Kiryu. I'll take it from here. Buki's waiting for you. Yeah, that's the same text as always. I don't mind skipping text, as long as it's something we've read 10 times before anyway. Sorry for all the trouble my men put you through today. I'll make sure our members understand we're being targeted by the Reapers and have them take it to heart. Kiryu, well done. Here is your award. Appreciate your hard work. Lovely, lovely amber. 120,000. No, I'll give you a reward. It's a free visit to the Hall of Heroes. I've never been there myself, but I've heard they've got a free bar. medieval. Please come again. We're really counting on you. Okay. They're filthy ants. Scam! One of the best lines in the game. What would you like to do now? View requests. Okay. This is the last one, so we might as well do this now. Unless it unlocks a load more, but we'll see. Takayami, the Masked Assassin. Unknown, eh? Uses unique weapons. Interesting. Hiding in deserted places around Kamurocho. So.
I wonder if they've got a wolf spirit.
What was that?
Unknown.
Oh, yeah. Yeah, you have to ride up and down the very edge of an island to be able to find him or something. Pokemon. your target hitman is Takayama. I always try to explain references just in case anyone wants to join in and how funny they are. A mysterious assassin who has hidden his true identity and left no evidence of his previous crimes. So how do you know he's an assassin then? Isn't that kind of a logical point? He's killed loads of people. How do you know? We've got no evidence for it. So how do you know he did? We have very little information on him and no clues as to his appearance or his current location. Some reports say he wears a mask, and we can assume he only operates in deserted places where his appearance would not attract any unwanted attention. Yeah, or somewhere where there's loads of people in masks, which I can't think of anywhere obvious, but... To be honest, they're probably going to mark it on the map anyway. And I'm guessing where it is, but we'll see. I reckon it's that little parking lot in the Champions District. Because I can't think of anywhere else.
Can't be the crew from Judgment, because that's... he would be about 12 now.
How old would he be now? Oh, about 80?
Suppose so,
yeah. You can't leave me alone with him. Are you going to tell Father Jack? Oh, hey, Kiryu. Hey. What would you say is the most deserted place in this city? Is it right here on this pavement because no one wants to listen to you? Ah! No. burn! You know, that's a really suspicious question, right? I know you're a good guy, though. No, I want to kill someone and not have anyone find the body. Oh, I see. But go up here, go left there. I'd say it gets pretty deserted as soon as you go north of Shikifuku Street. But not true, there's loads of people up there. Especially back behind the Yoshida Batting Center. It's so deserted. It's like the place is haunted. Behind the batting center. See, I'm thinking, right, most of the Yakuza games so far have allowed you... You remember that roof that you can jump off? There's that little gap. I think that's what they're talking about, but I don't know if you can get back there. But we'll see. Behind Yoshida Batting Center, there's a construction site around there. Yeah, so... yeah, maybe he's in the construction site then, I don't know. Oh, did I not see it on the map? Yeah, it's on the map, so... maybe. Because there's a set of stairs back there, or at least there was in the other games, that you could go up and then jump off the top of that building, but... Avoid the fight. There we go. We could do some food, actually. We'll go this way. What would you like? Barbecue, hot. No, what was it? Barbecue, grade, hot, or I don't know, something or other. Fill in the gaps.
Teal, grey, hot.
There you go. Steak, filet, hot. There you go.
Fish.
Yeah, fish. Today's fish is trout a la creme. Enjoy your meal. Fish! Yeah. He orders about six at a time and then gets really ill. When I said about host hair.
Yes. Mm-hmm.
Yep. Literally that guy there. He's got the same hair as that NPC I was talking to.
Host
Club Quest. Club Quest.
Like Dragon Quest, but with host stars.
Ah. Do you know, that would be genuinely amazing if one day there was, if they go, oh, you can buy a Famicom or whatever, or like an NES or whatever the equivalent would be. Famicom, I suppose. Yeah. And you can use it to decorate your little home. And then when you take it home, you can actually buy games that they would then sort of put in for, like, you know, you pay a quid or whatever and you unlock some game. Or, you know, like you unlock them in some way or buy them from a shop in here. And if they unlocked Dragon Quest, honestly, I would play that on stream. It's brilliant. It's a very, very early RPG, so it's pretty basic, but it's still fun. It's one of those ones where, you know, obviously you have to grind between towns and all that sort of thing, but it's still pretty good. Oh, they said the Reaper Tokoyami would be lurking in a place where there weren't any people around. This is the most deserted area in Kamurocho, but I don't see anyone wearing a mask. Tell you what I do see. Oh, don't move. I love how he says there's no people around here. What are those two people walking past then? I mean...
NPCs.
Yeah, so not deserted then. So, rubbish. Yeah, I was going to say, when he said, oh, the back there's deserted, I thought, no, it isn't. I've had fights back there before. I've seen NPCs and knocked people over. There's a guy on his phone there. It's not exactly private, is it? Anyway, don't move. If you ever come looking for me again, I'll kill you. If you know what's good for you, you'll stop poking around in other people's business. Okay. Was that the Reaper Tokoyami? He didn't turn around while he was talking to him. He was like, are we going to have to chase after him? Because we've got upgraded chase now. Oh. Hey, did you see a suspicious looking man in a mask? It was probably this guy. I told you to mind your own business. There, that's him. Wait. You were the one who threatened me just now? Ignore my warning, will you? Then it's time for you to pay the price. Oh, as in...
Dreamcast.
Yeah. Actually, yeah, Sega Dreamcast got mentioned in a sub-story in Like a Dragon, if I remember right. I can't remember what the context was, but I think Zhao mentioned it.
Yeah, he made a reference to the VMU, I think.
Okay, this guy's faster than I thought he'd be. Whoa, okay. They said unconventional weapons, so... I love his little dive thing as he throws the knives. What, okay, so I can counter punch, but can I tiger drop? Yes, I can. Excellent. Right, okay, we've answered that question then.
It'd be interesting if we charged up his hand and then threw five knives at once.
Yeah, exactly. Yeah, like a medieval thing. Oh, I just got why you said that now. I was going to say, oh, like medieval. I know that is literally what you meant. Okay. Okay. Read about it in your cone tracks. Well, another time to finish it. this one might finish him off. Nope, okay. Almost though. I've got to say, I've got to work out how to unlock that third one so we can just see what it's like and have some more options. Haha, Tiger Drop finisher. Nice. After all that. Probably nearly Tiger Drop him like twice. Ugh. Don't you usually wear a mask? I used to wear one when I was with the Yakuza, but I don't anymore. Why not? I thought you wanted to...
Nothing anymore.
Yeah, exactly. I don't join them anymore. They're not round. Yeah, they are. I used to run them as their chairman. What? Yeah. Why not? I thought you wanted to hide your identity. A masked imposter showed up, pretending to be me. He ruined my reputation and got me kicked out of my family. Besides, wearing a mask around Kamurocho just makes you stick out like a sore thumb. Yeah, which is why he hangs out around this completely deserted area as people walk past with shopping bags talking on their phones. Sure, why not? They could have at least... this is why I thought they were going to use that little car park in the Champions District, because no one's ever in there. I don't know how that's less deserted than here, but sure, why not? Although that IF7 guy's there now, isn't he? With his electronic VR fighting machine, so maybe not. I'll give you that. Ugh. These days, the best way to hide your identity is to wear a suit. Ugh. In this city, a suit is a mask of its own. Ah, very philosophical. You've got a point there. Are you with the HLA? Yeah, I am. I'll go with you, but I'm not talking. I know you're probably not the kind of guy to talk, but you've got the wrong idea about the HLA. What? HLA is an organization that helps ex-Yakuza. They're not your enemy. They aren't going to force you to confess anything. Once you meet them, you just might form a different opinion of them. Beep.
And all this time I thought they were lesbians.
All this time I thought it was hot lesbian action. They weren't hot, they weren't lesbian, and there was no action. Great work, Kiryu. I'll take it from here. Waiting for your headquarters. Mm-hmm. So we'll see if this unlocks more or not. Good work. I'm glad you're okay. We thought you were looking for a masked man, but I guess we were completely wrong. Yes, yes, you were. Kiryu, well done. Here is your reward. There you go. Yeah, okay. 120,000 yen. Please come back. Yep, okay. Just want to see if there's more. There is no new information about Hitmen. Nope. Okay. So, what I'm curious about is, does that now put his picture on the... Yeah, so that picture wasn't there before. I just wondered if opening it would show his face. So, yeah, that's interesting. They actually update the target information even after you've done it. Huh. So you can't do them again or anything, I would have thought. I mean, obviously not, but... Okay. So, yeah, that seems to be that for now. And more will unlock, I don't know, in another chapter or something, so... Fun though. Right, okay, so right, where's the nearest thing? Okay. Yeah. Right. So now we have less options to do, but they are still options nonetheless. There is the thing that I can't think of, which I'll probably remember as soon as we end the stream or something later on and then go, oh shit. We could start host this thing, or we could do another sub story, or oh, we could get into this fight, I suppose. Oh, I thought I could start the fight with a tiger drop. That would have been cool. Oh, I fucking hate the guys with tasers. It's so annoying. There we go. Now who's annoying? Me, that's who!
Brown's not the best color for a puffy jacket.
Hold on. Oh, no, okay. There we go. Right, sorry, what'd you say?
I said brown's not the best color for a puffy jacket.
No, quiet. I always think it looks weird when they're dark. Grey, maybe. Okay, black's fine. But, yeah, brown is an odd choice for a jacket of that sort of type. But, yeah, weird.
Especially the type of shiny brown that he had on.
Yeah, it's weird. Brown is not a colour you really think of traditionally as being shiny. It's just a bit... Okay. Yeah, so thoughts? Hostess or sub-story? There's one there. One there.
Hostess.
Hostess, okay. So, first of all... now, it's a different club, and I don't actually know where the club is.
Not I suppose Sega. I could...
Oh, there we go. Look, Sega! Ah. Right, so we need to go to Meb first, because I need to ask about the hostess and write down any details he gives me. The only information I really want to know is what food and drink they like, because anything else... Oh, she's really independent, and it's like, yeah, okay, but how does that help me? Okay. I mean, maybe that would help you answer certain questions, but... Okay, this is one of the ones where you're back towards a window. We haven't done one of these in a while. I love how we have to go in after this and ask the guy for help, even though we just smashed his window, but sure.
Bicycle.
Goodbye, sickle. I thought I could keep him in the air for a while. It's just a little airborne. He's still good. He's still good.
I could juggle and take him.
Yeah, exactly. 30 grand. That is how I won a lot of the fights in the Colosseum. You get them knocked up against the wall, so to speak. Not knocked up, but you know what I mean. And then you just hit them with combos from behind and then hope they bounced again. And then you could keep it going for quite a while if you were lucky. Okay. Our store's a wreck right now, but we're not going out of business. I love the fact that you get different text if you fought someone just before you go in. Brilliant. Okay, so... Which is the one we did? It was Jewel, wasn't it? Shine. Yeah, okay. So these are the three for Shine, so we'll be starting... Oh, actually, you can see back there above his head the three women from Shine, weirdly enough. So there you go. Or Lime. Imagine going to a club called Lime. Right, we'll just do them in order, because it'll just be easier. Rin Sasaba. Tell me about Rin Sasaba. Rin is one tough girl who tells you exactly what's on her mind. Right, she's going to be annoying, then I can tell already.
Well, she's either going to be annoying or brilliant.
Yeah, true. Brilliant in it. Go on.
Because she'll tell you exactly what you want to know.
Yeah, well, true. What sort of food do you want? Chocolate and cake. All right, okay, good.
Yes.
Men can't get enough of her thick... Ooh. Oh, I suck her accent. I got excited there.
Right.
And sharp wit... What they're going to describe as thick. She's 25, which in hostess terms makes her about 87. she's 25, a Capricorn, and her blood type's A. I warn you, unlike most hostesses, Rin doesn't drink at all. Right, that is handy. Okay, let me write down Rin doesn't drink, so we don't buy our alcoholic drinks. Rin doesn't drink. Now that is handy. Hee-hee-hee, once you get a taste of that sharp Osaka-fed wit of hers, you'll be completely hooked. Okay, cool stuff. Right, so... I need to go to a save point, because I need to pick up... where is Shine, actually? I can't remember. Map, and then it'll be... Shine... Oh, it's the one down on the corner down there. Okay, fine. Yeah. Right. I'll get this save point. I'll get the items we need, and then I'll take the taxi down to the bottom and then go straight there.
Have we done okay. What's Club Asia?
Club Asia is the bikini bar, I think. I've gone completely the wrong way. Yeah, Club Asia is not... I thought that as well. I thought that was a third hostess club, so I thought it was another set of three women... But it's literally the place where you get the bikini sort of dances and that. Well, we've had a couple of sub-stories before. B, But yeah, it's a good question anyway, because I asked exactly the same thing at that place when I first saw what it was called. It's got the word club before it, so it threw me off. Right, okay. Oh, we never tried that... Wow, collapsible hammer, attack 140. Nice. We haven't tried that spear yet that I sorted out. Right, let's dump 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. And then we need... Dragon... Necklace, charisma ring, and I want to try that dragon shirt as well, because it says it's charming, so we'll see. charisma ring, where's that? There it is. Alright. Okay, yeah, the popularity bracelet makes you popular with the ladies, but I don't know, I found the others did better, so whatever. Right, what else do we need? Oh, we need presents as well, because we got a couple of bags from a couple of quests we did. They'll be in mystery, I guess. I did a load of gambling off stream as well, which is why I've got more money now. Forgot to mention that earlier, right? Wallet, bag, ring. I think there was something else. Or do they put all the presents together? Wasn't there a something skin bag? Yeah, there we go, caviar skin bag. I'll grab one of them. So these items are random then. They're just in the order you put them in the box in. That's annoying. A lot of them do seem to be collected in a group though. So I don't know. Anyway, we've got a couple of presents there and items and stuff. Yakobu says he's off to bed. Late as a night lying secret, Yakobu in chat. Thank you very much, Neo. Your presence was much appreciated tonight. And we will see you another time, baby. Good night.
Yes. Good night, Neo.
Good night. If I can run the other way, I can avoid this fight and correct where I was going, because I was going to get a taxi to the bottom of town. The bottom of town! Right, okay. Do you know, actually, you know, that was another thing I was going to say as well. I hoped that the running training would speed up our normal walking speed, but it doesn't, so... Oh well. I must say, for really cheap cola, that Morrison's stuff's quite nice. Actually got to remember to equip the items. Okay, dragon shirt. That. And that. Right. So, unless those two pull down what the dragon shirt does, then we should get a really big boost just from walking in there, let alone doing anything. So, right, okay. Let's go this way, and then we've got to go north from there. And then it's on the corner of this... I don't know what you call it, section? I don't know. Hmm. But yeah, it's on the corner of this section anyway, like the collection of buildings. That's another thing as well. If someone's standing still right in the middle of the road, walk behind them, because you normally avoid the fight that way. It is this corner, isn't it? Or did I see it wrong? Oh, no, it's literally right behind me. There it is. Yeah, Club Shine. There you go. Is that Shine? Yeah, Shine. Okay. Shine.
Shine.
Cheer. We've not been in here before. Yes, or at least not in this game, anyway. We're calm. Will you be visiting our club today? No, I'm still outside. That's like in 40 Towers where Sybil walks into the kitchen and goes, Basil, are you still here? And he goes, no, I left a few minutes ago, darling. And he's supposed to be fixing the car. And the classic, right, that's it, I'm going to give you a damn good thrashing. And then he goes and gets the branch and smashes his car with it. And there's a little model I saw once. It was way too expensive, but it was of the corner of the street where it happens. It was inside this little box, like a diorama, and there's the car half on the pavement and Basil using a branch to hit it with. It was brilliant. I'd love to own one of them, but I think last time I saw them, they wanted like 20 quid for it, and I thought, it's tiny. It's funny, but I don't know if it's worth 20 quid, but I'll have to see how much they are now, though. Probably even more. Right. Rin Sasaba, who does not like alcohol. Then right this way, sir.
Rinse and repeat.
Ha! Ooh, she's great. Which is weird for this game, because of the graphics and the way they draw people's faces, it's surprising she's actually mildly attractive, so well done. Oh, I completely missed that. Okay, I didn't see what it said. I was too busy commenting on her face. Hope you're into cat's eye girls. As long as you don't make any lame takoyaki jokes, then we're cool. Nice to meet you. Yes, nice too. And then as I'm saying nice too, I'm already thinking of takoyaki puns. I don't know, something about octo and then pussy. I don't know. Nice to meet you too. I'd like to see your octo pussy. You look so delicious, I could put... Go on, what was that?
John... No, Sean... No, wait, hold on.
All I will say is you... Sean Walsh, yeah.
Yeah, Sean Walsh.
Yeah, that's it. While we're doing this mode, you might have to speak a bit louder because the music in the background of this club is really quite loud, especially in my headphones. But yeah, I could turn it down, I suppose. But yeah, just remember that. So, what are we having? Yeah, you don't get any boost for the items the first round. So when we come in the second time, we'll find out how well the stuff's done. Right, so they're all alcohol. That's alcohol. That's alcohol. Cassis is alcohol, I think. Orange juice or water. Right, well, I mean... Her saying she doesn't like alcohol is brilliant, really, because there's only two drinks and they're the cheapest ones anyway. So I'm guessing she really likes orange juice. If not, then the free drink. She's a cheap date. Let's pick orange juice, see how well that goes. This should be good. Oh, that was a whole hit, whole heart on its own. Wow, nice. How do you know that was one of my favourites? Nice. Pick the right one. Okay, let me write that down. Orange juice. Orange. Yeah, maybe we'll get along after all.
That's pigeon English, isn't it?
Yeah, I think so. They said what was it? There was some proposed thing where it was like a mix of Japanese and English and other things, and orange juice was odansu.
Yeah.
It just sounds like someone Japanese who's barely learned English and can just about say enough letters for you to go, oh, orange juice, right, okay. You want something to eat? Now, I've got no clue as to what she likes food-wise, but she doesn't like alcohol, so nothing that goes well with alcohol, I imagine. So, probably not that. That's a good point, actually. I've just thought of something. She really likes oranges. Fruit platter. Fruit platter would have oranges in it. Maybe. Or chocolate. I mean, who doesn't like chocolate? I'm going to go with fruit platter, even though it's the most expensive one, just on the basis that she might like oranges. She likes orange juice. So, fruit platter it is. Yeah, I'll have this. Okay, I got half a heart out of that, so that's good. Fruit plate equals half, and orange juice equaled a whole one, didn't it? Yeah, okay. Alright, save. I'll just save that so I've got the information for later, because I'll probably forget. Could I have a few bites? Well, let's get... Oh, was that me saying that? Or maybe let's get to water, yeah, okay. Also, I've just noticed the massive torso with big old tits behind us. Why didn't I notice that before? Okay. I'll have this for you right away. It's got no arms or head, but still, tits. Cheers. Canned pie indeed. Don't drink it all in one gulp now, because that's what I'll be doing later on. What? Nothing. Let me get that for you.
Genuinely trying to think how you would miss that.
Here's something you might like to know. This hostess thing, it's just a part-time gig. Believe it or not, I work in an office during the day. Alright, see.
It's annoying because I can't make the joke work.
What were you trying to do? Maybe I can help.
Well... I was trying to come up with a joke for... why you missed what was in the background.
Oh, I see. You didn't try your breast to notice it?
Yeah.
That'll do. I mean, it works. I mean, that's our part-time pun. That can be the pun until we think of something better. And if we don't, then that can be it. Or we can be the breast of friends, which might be the name of this episode now I think about it. Breast of friends. I'm going to write that down as a possible thing I might call this video. Breast of friends. Okay. Let's see, right, okay. I see, this is your way of waking a quick buck, huh? Pretty much. Only downside is I can't drink, not even a sip. I thought it was just that you didn't like drink. Alcohol gives me these huge migraines. Oh, okay, right, so she gets migraines, so there you go. Yeah, go figure. I never exactly pegged you for a... Well, never exactly pegged you for a drinker. Maybe later I will. Now wait, that's your job, isn't it? Well, good, because I ain't one by a long shot. And the manager here nearly blows a fuse because I don't drink with customers. Why would he give a shit? Oh, wait, because you can get more money out of people if you drink alcohol. Yeah, true. I'll bet he does. Yes. You work in a hostess club, but you can't drink. Yes, don't tell anyone, but I'm underage. What? Nothing.
No, it's more of a manager problem, really.
Pretty much. Well, I'd have thought that the more money she makes, the bigger cut she gets. So it sort of means she earns less as well. But then maybe she gets more out of people from prisons and stuff. So maybe it balances out. I don't know. Let me ask you, Kiryu. Is it bad that I don't drink on the job? Give me your honest opinion. To be honest, if it's going to give you massive migraines, then obviously it's fine. I mean, if it's a decision, then that's different. If you're just going, nah, I just don't drink because I can't be arsed. But it's literally making you ill, so I wouldn't worry about it. I'm surprised you can get away with it. Well, that's possibly to do with the manager. Can you really not drink at all? If she gets really bad migraines, then I would assume not. As long as I can drink, then no problem. Well, I mean, given the manager thing, she mentioned the manager, so maybe it's the first one. It's probably not the middle one. And he's not drinking because they both chose orange. So I reckon number one.
I don't know.
I'm surprised you can get away with it. What do you reckon?
Well, yeah, the third one might be sort of rubbing salt in the wound.
Possibly, yeah.
Second one sounds the most sensitive, I think.
Can you really not drink at all? I'm wondering if she goes, I just told you I wouldn't, and gets really arsey about it, but I could be wrong on that. Surprised you can get away with it? Maybe, oh, I don't know. Yeah, it's definitely a toss-up between one and two, isn't it? It's a pity there's no one else in chat to give a casting vote. But yeah, what number would you have gone with anyway?
Second one,
okay. Can you really not drink? Do you know what? The second one could go wrong, but it could go right. So I'm going to go with that. And then if that wasn't the right answer, then I'm guessing it was number one, but we'll see. This is a short session anyway, so can you really not drink at all? That's what I said. Yeah, okay, she might take this wrong now, so we'll see. Oh, even putting my lips to the glass gets my temples pounding. Would you like me to pound something? No. Ouch. Better stay away from it then. Yep. Then there's the fact that my face gets all red when I'm drunk, which I don't like. And if that ain't enough, I've never drunk a drink I like to begin with. Yeah, that's pretty much where I am on alcohol, really. I will try something that's alcoholic, but 99% of the time, I just don't like it, honestly. I'd rather just drink cola or water or something, but, yeah.
I took a quarter down.
I mean, obviously, there's other reasons why I can't drink alcohol anyway, but I never really started drinking anyway, so... I tried, those sort of alco-pop things, some of those were alright, but then they were really sugary anyway, so they were aimed at sort of teenagers anyway, I think. So yeah, which is weird, because you still can't drink underage, which is why they eventually sort of fell out of favour, I think, but... Hooch was quite nice, I seem to remember. That was like a lemon sort of... really sort of tart lemon sort of drink. That was alright. And, Smirnoff Ice was okay. I mean, these are all like girls' drinks or like drinks for teenagers, but they're the only alcoholic drinks I ever really liked. So, there was, what was the other thing as well? It was a real woman, like quote unquote woman's drink, but I really liked it. Peach Schnapps. That was nice. I thought, because it tasted of peaches, and I thought, I like peaches. So yeah, there you go.
Peaches.
Peaches. I like to eat peaches. Are you? Someone with a hostess named Peaches. I love to eat peaches. They say you lose out on half of life's pleasure when you can't drink, or something to that effect. Not true, baby. Though I will admit there's a part of me that gets a little jealous seeing folks cut loose and party it up with their booze. Not really sure why. Maybe you'll find out someday. Okay, that gave no boost at all. So that was the neutral answer. So I'm guessing the top one was positive and maybe the bottom one was negative. But
it
anyway.
Took some off.
Did it?
Yeah, caught it.
Oh, I genuinely didn't even notice. Wow, okay, I don't know when that happened. Normally there's like a purple rain effect over their head. Yeah, that's what I was looking for. I didn't even notice that. Well done. All right, Kiryu, hear me out on this one. Go on. I know I work at a place like this and all, but I can't stand dealing with old dudes. What? This is hilarious, because you're the only person in town who doesn't think we're really fucking old. they really just need to kick the bucket already. Bit harsh. You really don't like older men, huh? Not at all. They make me want to vomit up the contents of my stomach and then some. Alright, bit harsh. Ugh. Just sitting next to him gives me the creeps. Yeah, I mean, again, everyone thinks we're old, so the fact you don't is odd, but okay. Oh, but don't worry, Kiryu. You're in the safe zone, but only barely. Yeah, that makes us feel special, thanks. So you prefer younger men? Are you just being nice to me? You're pretty blunt, you know. Now, that last one is an interesting answer, because they did say she was blunt, didn't they? In Meb. So... yeah, I might go with that just out of... If I hadn't heard that, I might have gone for number one. But yeah, I'm going to go with three, because they said she was and she might agree. You're pretty blunt, you know. Damn straight. I ain't made of sugar, so why not sugarcoat the truth like a tiger drop? My style is to spice things up instead. At least that's what people around me say. Okay. It's like clapping like a seal when they flip. They do their flippers and they sort of go with the wind as they move towards each other. Fair enough. Ain't that how it's supposed to be, though? I mean, sure, you can butter people up all you want, but that's just going to end up biting both parties in the butt, right? Sorry. I suppose that has some merit to it. So you agree? Well, I read it like that. Well, we got our quarter of a heart back, lovely. So you agree, then it looks like we'll get along just fine. Yeah, good. I was hoping we'd get along. Get along, little doggy. We're not running too late, are we? I don't think so. But it's getting to be that time. Oh, was that literally the end of the session? Yeah, you always get a short session to start with, so I'm not too worried about it. We only got 1.5 hearts. I'd say that went pretty well, don't you? I doubt I will. What? I didn't even get a chance to read that. You've got Rin's business card. I'll have to look back at that later on. If I remember, which I won't. Here is your bill. Where is Sybil? Sybil? No, Sybil, my wife Sybil. Where is she? I don't want the bill. I run the bloody place. Why would I need the bill? Hope to see you again. Yeah, okay, cool. Thanks for coming to see me. I always think that's weird when someone waves someone away and they're that close to them. It seems like the sort of thing you should only do when you're about 10 metres apart. Weird. It's like waving, you stretch out your arm to wave and their palm's about an inch away from your nose. Email. Yeah,
I think what we should do is go and dye our hair grey and then put lines on our face and then come back.
Yeah, and then go, ha ha ha, you bitch.
And then, yeah, and then see if she turns inside out.
Yeah, so she vomits up the contents of her stomach, and then some. What, like those, have you ever seen those frogs that do that? It's some sort of toad or something. And basically, when they're ill, they regurgitate their entire stomach outside of their body and turn their stomach inside out, and then use their hands to wipe off all the stuff that was inside their stomach and then swallow their stomach back down again. It's really weird to see it. It's some sort of frog or toad or some sort of bull toad or something. But yeah, I think they're the ones that live in the rainforest, because obviously there's shit tons of stuff there that's poisonous. So the fact that they have that ability means it probably happens quite a lot. So they eat like poison dart frogs or whatever, and then have to get the poison out after they've digested the bit they can eat or whatever. I don't really know how it works, but yeah, weird. Thanks for requesting me today, Grey Cat. I hope you'll keep it up. Well, if you keep exciting me, I will. I can't wait to see you again. Thanks, Yellow Cat. And. Need to do that deeper, really. Right, now is the time to see how much the shirt gives us in terms of a boost when we come in. Unless the shirt gives us a really big boost, then the other items we're wearing bring it down. But I don't know, we'll have to see, I guess. It's all experimentation. Oh, we got a card as well. I thought I mentioned that. Rin, right this way. Rin Tin Tin. Welcome to the club. Welcome to the club. Being in the club. Let's make it a fun night. Whoa, look at the boost off of that. Wow. Okay, that is cool. That shirt was worth getting. Jesus. Right, okay. That was for basically gorging ourselves at restaurants. Oh, nice. Well, don't you look spiffy today? Good job, Kiryu. Nice. Should I give her a gift? Yeah, sure, why not? We've got some on us. Right, I've got no idea about what sort of gift she'd like, so... wallet, bag, ring... She's wearing jewellery, so maybe a ring? Let's find out. How about this one? Whoa! Oh, she liked that. Okay, cool. No way. I've been looking all over for this. Thanks a ton! Don't know why I read it like that, but... Thanks a ton! That's my best impression of a woman, because I can't do high voices. So what are we having? Okay, so... Oransu. Yep. How do you know that was one of my favourites? Because it was your favourite last time? sure, why not? And then I think the fruit platter went down well, didn't it? Yep, okay, so we're at 4.5 already. Now I think we can boost into the second lot of 5, if I remember rightly. So we need to, it's not just, we have to do this whole question session just for half a heart, we need the other 5 as well, so. But I think if you get past like 6 or 7, you get the first date, I think, so yeah. If I'm thinking of that right. Cheers. Now, interestingly, they've actually made the drinks the right colour, given that's supposed to be orange juice, so... I was going to say, I wonder if she doesn't drink because she's pregnant, but then we wouldn't be smoking next door, I suppose, because, you know... I was passing by this elementary school in the afternoon when I saw this kiddo swinging around on the monkey bars. Seeing that reminded me of back when I was a kid. I used to do that too. I was actually pretty athletic, you know. I can only imagine. Oh, that that reminds me of a thing I saw this video where these people went, oh, look, there's loads of cute children, loads of cute tiny Japanese children. And when I say tiny, I mean like 3 and 4 or whatever. And they were all in their little yellow caps with their little bags on. It was so cute. And they saw them marching out of this thing, and they had a camera with them because they were filming something or other. And they filmed these kids, and the teacher went, oh, everyone wave to the man, and they all went, hello, and all this, because they know a bit of English and all that. And I was thinking, imagine that same scenario here. You go, there's a man outside of a school, and he's filming some children, and the teacher goes, wave to the man with the camera. Imagine that here. But because they knew over there that nothing was going to happen. It's broad daylight, there's teachers around, and they've got a camera on, and they're not going to film themselves doing anything, are they? So it's just that thing of, there's a man outside the school with a camera. Is that it, though? Are they doing anything? And it's like, well, how do you know people haven't been doing this all day and you just haven't noticed them till now? It's ridiculous.
See, because I was taking pictures of everything that I looked at pretty much, but I went past the school and I was like, I can't tell if I should...
Yeah, I think
I'd be okay doing that.
I think in Japan, also, the fact you're foreign probably would help, because they go, well, he's a foreigner, he's taking pictures of everything. When we go abroad, we take pictures of everything, so they'd probably think it was funny, to be honest. Hey, look, a foreigner, huh? And then just think, you know. I mean, unless you're, like, you know, hanging around the change rooms, taking pictures through the window or whatever, I doubt they'd really care.
Yeah.
You know, it's just, you know, you go, oh, look, some children or whatever.
So ingrained in my head.
Yeah, exactly. From here, that everyone assumes that if you stand within 2 miles of a child, you must be some sort of child molester. Just weird, like, sort of logic.
Yeah.
Mm. I've always been against the suspicion without proof thing. Just going, oh, look, it's suspicious. And it's like, yeah, but they're not doing anything, so what does it matter? Oh, hold on. Share play thing, let me add you back in. Yeah, it's one of those weird things where you think, you know, it's being guilty based on something that someone else has done in the past that's got nothing to do with you, and you think, oh, I don't know, it's just weird. To me,
sort
it's
of like two reasons why I wouldn't take it. Because one is like, because it feels awkward, because, you know, because it's frowned upon in this country, and then
yeah.
The other is because you wouldn't necessarily be able to show anyone the picture, because they might say something.
It depends. I mean, if it depends what you use. I mean, if you had some sort of website or whatever, and you just put loads of pictures on it, or you were making a video or something, and it was one of the many pictures within a sort of a thing, I doubt many people would go, that one's weird. The rest of them are fine, but that one's weird. Mm. And it's like, well, you know, it's no weirder than taking a picture of, well, anything. If you're in public. Also, the other thing is, it's not illegal, so why do people give a shit? That's always been my other thought as well about this sort of stuff. Either something's illegal or it's not. If it's illegal, then stop them from doing it. If it isn't, then leave them the fuck alone. Because they're not doing... Until they do something illegal, don't worry about it. You know, it's... you go, oh, but this person's taking pictures of my kids, or they might be taking them home and wanking over them. And it's like, yeah, they might be, but what can you do about it? I don't know what you want to happen. We need to stop them from doing it. Doing what? They're taking pictures in public. It's a right. It's not against the law. I don't understand. I don't know. It's just weird to me anyway. But it's one. I know it's a delicate subject, but it's just one of those things I find odd. But yeah. Anyway, there was this kid at my school who couldn't do a reverse flip on the Mars. Well, isn't that really difficult? And it's, well, yeah. If you're doing a reverse flip, that's even more difficult. So I used to tell him, you can do it, and try to cheer him on. But he couldn't pull it off, no matter how many times he tried. There's a pun in there. Perhaps he needs to come to this club. He'd pull it off here. Instead, he'd get all sad and start wailing away. Then everyone would gather around him and tell him it was fine. And one day, he decided his monkey bar days were over, just like that. He got used to being doted on, see? See? That was like a sort of 1920s detective. Yeah, well, see? That's too bad. I just can't respect that, you know? Putting in all that work only to give up out of nowhere. It's a total waste. But then everyone I tell this to is like, Rin, that's too cold. Give the kid some credit. Well, he was a child, let's face it. I mean, I get that effort's important and all, but you gotta at least make some progress in the end. Well, what's the point of all that hard work? That massively depending on what you're talking about. But, yeah. Make some progress in the end. I'll show you. Go on.
The second most annoying.
The second most annoying hostess. And then just Kiryu's face appears and goes, just look confused, and then floats away. I'd love that at the beach. My favourite bit about that is the throwing the skimming the stone out and it hitting the back of that old fisherman. What, you bloody feckin'? And he starts to come back into shore. What's your take, Kiryu? Okay, so, you should give him credit for trying. It's all about results, like what you said. Showing effort is something of a virtue. Right, well, given that she's blunt, I imagine... See, the thing is, I wouldn't say the middle one, personally, but I would say it in terms of what's happening now, because I imagine that's probably what she wants to hear. You should give him credit for trying. That was what she said she wasn't doing, so... Showing effort is something of a virtue. Maybe. But...
It's one of the bottom two.
Yeah, I'd have thought so. Also, I just noticed, if you listen to this music, every so often they say shine. not doing it now. No, I don't know, they're not doing it now, but there's a bit where they go, shine, shine, shine. Right, okay, so... I just... Because we're not sure, I just go with the middle one, because it seems the most likely out of those two. The middle one seems kind of... Well, the bottom one seems kind of middle ground-ish. So... I can't imagine... Okay, unless she's like that annoying hostess, where when she said something, we literally agreed with her, and then she disagreed with us, and it was like, hold on, how does the logic of this work? But yeah, I'm going to just agree with her and see how that goes. Because that will give us some basis as to how we should answer the following questions, maybe. It's all about results. Like what you said. Go on. Well, the only way to reach your goal is to give it everything you've got. But if you don't reach your goal at all, then how do you know your efforts were worthwhile? That's a real good way to put it, Kiryu. You've got the same line of thinking as me. Yeah, that's what I was hoping would happen. Yeah, you think that's exactly the same way I do. Okay, so try and agree with her on everything then. Right, okay, she's one of them. I think that more and more people these days put on a work face and don't actually get work done. You know what I mean? No, I think everyone puts on a soy sauce face, actually. Which apparently isn't racist, but there you go. Who knew? Are you talking about the people at your main job? Well, yeah. I got no love for those losers. Ooh, harsh. It's like, if you can't get the proper results at the end of the day, then what are you even doing in the first place? Then what are you even... Yeah, I did read that right. Okay.
Like someone who does... Someone who leads the team of a door-to-door sales company.
Yeah, and it those sort of people. Those people that... For a very, very brief period, I sold stuff on phones. I never mentioned it to anyone because it lasted like a week, so it's not really worth mentioning because I only did it like three times. But just the people that were really good at that job and the guy who ran the place were just, I can't help but feel they were just, for want of a better phrase, massive twats. So, yeah, and the bloke would come in like stinking of drugs and but obviously drunk. And then would have a go at us because we were late because we hadn't gone into the office. Like, you've got the key. How the fuck were we supposed to get in, you knob? But whatever, anyway. Stupid idiot. And I never got paid properly. I was 30 quid short of the money they gave me. And I kept going in there and going, can I have the rest of my money? Oh, I won't forget it this time. Look, I'm writing it literally on the desk. And he's writing in big letters. And I thought, this is weird. And then go in later on and go, have you got my money? Oh, no, sorry, the cleaner came in and cleaned it off, so I forgot. And it's like, oh, for fuck's sake. After a while, I just gave up. I think he probably pocketed the 30 quid, but after a while, I didn't really give a shit. It was 30 quid to me was worth not having to talk to him ever again to me. So, yeah, whatever. I think it was 30 quid. Maybe it's 20 quid. I mean, think how much cold meats and cheese I could buy with that money. Think of the blocks of cheddar and slices of ham I could have got with that. Oh well. So, I was wondering, what about? I was wondering, how much cheese can you get for $20 in Camarocho? Do you get all aggressive when it comes to the women you like, or are you the type that makes them fall for you instead? Now there's a question. Personally, I can't say much on the topic. I mean the HLA, you know. Oh, what, the place with the hitmen? No. Oh, right. Who am I kidding? When I like a guy, I get so flustered I can barely look him in the eyes. Right, so she doesn't like us then, so that's good to know. Let alone make the first move. At the same time, I hate when they're too aggressive. Okay. Then, if you were to approach a guy you liked, how would you do it? Well, sort of back and forth, I imagine. Okay, so after meeting up and exchanging contact info, I'd start sending him a flood of emails on a daily basis. No, you can't have our phone number then. Oh, wait, she's already got it. Shit. Oh, well. This will be like Al Gore in that South Park game where he keeps sending text messages about Man Bear Pig and you can't get him to shut the fuck up. And you have to fight him, and unfortunately, he's a really hard boss. So if you've talked to him first, you have to put up with those messages for ages. You would?
Is that in the Sticks of Truth?
Yeah, because I've not played either of them. I've got both of them, but I've seen other people play them, so at some point they might do those on stream. But yeah, I'm pretty sure that's Stick of Truth, because I remember way more of that than I do from Fractured Butthole. So there you go. Yep, I'll drop a load of juicy Rin formation for him to devour. I don't even need to make a joke of that, do I? It's already there. Juicy Rin. Would you give me a Rin job? Sorry, just making myself laugh now. Rin job. There's another name that I might call this episode. Breast of Friends. Rin job. There we go. Okay. That way you can get some hints about how he needs to talk to me the next time we meet up. Expedites the whole process. That makes sense. What would be in those emails? Can you email me every day too? I love how that's one of the options. Yes, I want you to email me every day. Not really. Right, so that makes sense. That's just basically agreeing with her outright. What would be in those emails? That's curiosity, showing interest. Can you email me every day too? That could go right, but that's one of those answers that's sort of on the fence of whether it could go right or not.
I don't know. I want to see what happens.
What, with the can you and mummy every day too?
Yeah.
Yeah, I'm kind of intrigued as well. I think... Do you know what? I might risk losing the heart just for a really funny answer every now and then, but so we'll see. I mean, it might give us nothing. It might be a good answer. You never know. I think the top one was probably the right answer, though. Can you and mummy every day too? Huh? Come again? Well, I mean, I think I would be if you were emailing me every day. Da-dum-tsh. I'd like to know some Rin formation too. Nope, no can do. We ain't that close. You might be trying to pass that off as a joke. Yeah, I was hoping she would take it as a joke, but we lost quarter of a heart. Eh, that's not too bad. But that one fell flat as a busted tire, Kiryu. Kiryu, I'm going to guess your height is either at around, oh, I'd say 180 centimetres. Yes. What's that in feet and inches? I've got no idea.
It's supposed to be 6'2", I think.
180, no, not 280, that would make him a fucking giant. It's not Greg Davis, come on. Alright, 180 centimetres.
78.
You are?
Yeah.
Okay, it says 180 is 5'9", just about. Is that right? Well, that's what it says it is, so there you go. That would make 6 foot what? 6 foot is 182. I'm 6'1", I think. So I'm 186-ish, by the looks of things. So I'm taller than Kiryu, I don't believe that. Mind you, he is supposed to be Japanese, so... That's pretty close. Yeah, I'm going to quickly look up the Kiryu Yakuza wiki and see what it says on there. I'm guessing they had to estimate it based on how tall he is compared to everyone else. Physical. Height, 184, so he's 6 foot. So to say she was close is, I guess, true, because she was about 4 centimetres out. So that is pretty close. And he's only supposed to weigh 194 pounds. Don't know. In the Yakuza 3, I get the feeling he's a bit heavier. He looks wider. Good. Clap, clap, clap. A guy's got to be tall and imposing, you know. Sing. In order to meet your criteria? Yep. I'm short as heck, so I've been looking up to tall guys my whole life. Literally. I see. Now, if only your face was as cute or as hot, if only your face was as cute as those half or quarter Japanese guys, you'd be a really pretty boy, Kiryu. Thanks. I might even fall for you before I can stop the wheels of love from spinning. Okay then. Sorry?
Right, so I'm 5'11", and that's 180.
5'11" is 180, right? And it says he's 6 foot, which is like 4 centimetres more.
Yeah.
So, yeah, about that. Okay. Yeah, it's interesting to learn. Because I can't convert lengths and weights in my head. Because I know that a stone is 14 pounds, but that's about it. But then I can't do the maths to get to the number in the end anyway. Okay then. So what you look for in a man, So what you look for in a man as far as personality goes. Seems like there's a word missing there. What do you look for in a man as far as personality goes? Yeah, the word do was missing there. What you look for. It's like someone speaking... when they have Chinese people in this speaking Japanese, but they've got to translate them speaking bad Japanese into English. So they go, what you want? Yeah. To be honest, I don't have a particular type, if that's what you're asking. As long as he's tall, ripped and steamy... enough to make me melt on the spot. But, after all, that's the ideal image of a man, at least the way I see it. Guys like that can get a woman any time they please. Feels like I'm wearing nothing at all. Nothing at all. Stupid sexy Kiryu. Even if they are a little bit of a bad boy, that don't bother me either. Oh, because she's supposed to be speaking with an accent, isn't she? So that kind of makes sense why she would talk like that.
Yeah.
Sounds logical, says Spock Kiryu. Isn't personality more important? Guess that rules me out. It sounds most logical, sir. Not that I've watched the original Star Trek, but I know Spock is at least. Right, I'm going to guess just agree with her, because that's gone well so far. I probably would have said the middle one, but I think number one's probably going to be the way we go on this.
Personality more important.
Yeah, exactly. That is true, but then that's not what she said. So we've kind of if the last questions were anything to go by, we've sort of got to agree with her on most things. And my guess is, given that she didn't take that joke answer well, the joke answers are not going to be good answers to go for in a lot of cases. Not until we get to know her better. So I'm guessing. I'm just going to guess number one. I think on this one, just to see how that goes. Sounds logical, sir. Most illogical. Ain't it? Besides, who would go through the trouble of trying to figure out someone's personality before you even get to know them? That's just slapping labels on people. Okay, that's one way to put it, I suppose. Not to mention, people change over time, so whatever time you spent trying to figure them out is just going to be wasted anyway. Well, that's an interesting way to think of it, I suppose. Yeah, I guess you're right. Haha, looks like we see eye to eye then. Yeah, she loved that. We got that quarter of a heart back. Unless we can only fill the first five. I thought you could go into the second five without having to... Oh well, the session's coming to an end, so we can start another one anyway. Call it quits, because then we'll get the boost from the shirt and the rings and all the crap we're wearing at the moment. We done already? Yep. Yes, we are.
It's 12:20.
Thank you for coming to see me. Thank you for coming, sashimi. Ah, like fish, eh? Email. I saw this cute hat the other day and had to buy it. It was only 1,000 yen. That's what? Like £8 or something? I don't know. I'm not very good at conversions. Cheap and cute? How could I pass that up? Lol, I sound like an old lady. Thanks for coming today. Yeah, she goes, do you want to meet my grandmother? I don't like old men, but I like old women. And then it's Atsuko, and we go, nah! That'd be amazing. I'd love to...
£50.
Yeah, oh, there you go. That is cheap, then. Mind you, we haven't seen the hat. So...
I want it,
but she's got a new hat! Wow, okay, that was a bad one. Right, are you good to carry on, or are you too tired to carry on, or what?
I'm a little bit tired.
Okay, so do you want to end now?
Yes.
Okay, it's up to you. I'll just go until you're done, really. Right, let's go... Is that one wearing flares? Or are they pajama bottoms? Weird. Is it just me, or has she got no... Oh, no, she blinked. Okay, she is real. I was going to say, she's got no frames of animation. Because when I keep seeing her, I keep thinking that... Every time I go past her, I think she's way too still. She is moving very slightly, but...
Like that woman I shared in the... madhouse. So cool. Yeah.
That's just weird. Okay. Oh, fight. Oh, that's different. This guy with that jumper that we keep seeing has got a slightly different face to what he normally has. That's good. The thing is, right, they do all look good. No! What are you doing? That was more the Chinese, though, I think, which are a great bunch of lads, as we know. Yeah, that's what I meant. I bounced him off that lamppost. Swing! And stomp. Oh, really itchy nose. Sorry, I keep sniffing. Ugh. Okay. A fragrant 5 grand. Well, that's always what you want for money, isn't it? Fragrance. See, these guys standing still makes sense, because that's sort of their job. Also, what's on your sign? I've never looked at it. Bar Ayashi. Interesting. You do realise your sign is very low poly when I stand near it, don't you? And you have a pink jacket, and you are advertising. Nope. Hello. That appears to be a menu. And that appears to be for this place, maybe. Because, for some reason, I don't know why I remember this, but in one of the other games, I could look through the door and it was a record shop. But I don't think that was in the 80s when records would have been a new thing. I think it was like a retro sort of record store in maybe... It wasn't in like a Dragon. Maybe it was in Kiwami? I can't remember.
Is Don Quixote still here?
Yes, Don Quixote's still here. It's on the other corner. Yeah, you asked me about this the other week and I totally forgot. I said I was going to go there and then totally forgot. Donkey Hotel. It just slowly gets louder as you get towards it. Donkey! Body spray for men, which as it turns out is not a good thing to equip when you talk to thingies. Pepsi Nex. Kinmugi beer. Yeah, they sell all the ramen and all that shit. So, yeah, I'm disappointed by that. I've tried udon noodles now. I didn't think I'd like them, and I tried them, and I was right. I don't like them. Stuffed cat toy. See, I'm wondering what that's for. Is that for a quest? Because I bought one of those once and gave it to a hostess, and she didn't like it. So, oh, unless it's a crafting item. Huh. Maybe. Tonic shampoo. Anyway. Hey. Yes. I do have one request, actually. Oh, yes, we can get you anything you want. Yes, can you put the old music back on? I did enjoy it. Dun, 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 donkey. Me dancing to it. That's what spinning I most like about spot. Yeah, that's what I most like about the thumbsticks. You can go, dun, 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 donkey. Donkey Hotel. Okay, so, do I need to dump anything in the item box? Because I'll probably forget. I might keep those presents on me in case we do more hostessing next stream. I want to keep that, I want to put that on, actually, because we can use the hammer next time and see how good that is. Off stream, I might try and do the races, because I've already shown what they look like. It's just being able to do them or not, and I think that will require me failing it over and over and over again until I finally manage it, or just try it for so long I just give up. But we'll see. I'll write down anything that I win and update you next stream. Yeah, so this, I don't know what I'm going to call this one, but yeah, breast of friends and rin job are two possible answers. So there you go. Oh, I did call the last one Jeff in Tokyo Dream, by the way, because I couldn't think of anything better. So there you go. Yeah, because what I do is I flick through the stream and go, oh yeah, that's a good thing to call it. So because I've probably forgotten stuff tonight we've done that I could have thought of as good names. But yeah, so that dragon shirt is worth it for anyone wondering if that was any good for hostess improvement. So there you go. Let me just quickly do that. Okay, there we go. Right, okay, let's just save then. We should have saved throughout the stream as well, because I keep forgetting to do that. because if we lose it, we lose hours of progress otherwise, technically. Also, bit of that to finish off the night. Pasta bake. Right, okay. Which I'll be eating the rest of in a minute. It was a smoked sausage and tomato and basil mixed pasta bake. Where it's like that pasta where some of it's green and some of it's orange. They're like made out of different herbs and stuff, I guess. Really nice. With cheese and aromat. So
a little bow ties.
No, they're oh god, watch I don't know what the technical name for it is, but spirals. What is spiral pasta? There's a name for it. Spiral pasta. If I can't see it straight away, I'll just give up. But spiral pasta. There's a whole list of pasta there, but that might take ages. Farfalle is bow ties. Yeah. When what's it called? Alan Partridge is trying to impress his guest, and it's about, I'll have this pasta fettuccine. He goes, can I have it? But can I have it with that pasta that looks like little Action Man bow ties, please? Action Man bow tie pasta. Yes, that's it. tricolour pasta. There we go. Because it's green, yellow, and orange, and it says tricolour rotini. Oh, because of rotation. Yeah, that makes sense. Rotini. I think that's what it is, anyway. Yeah, I mean, these are American packets, so our stuff's obviously different, but I think it's probably just rotini pasta. So, yeah, there you go. Yeah, corkscrew shape, basically. Right, yes, so that's the end of the stream. Yes, thank you, everyone, for coming tonight. And thank you to Neo for the 10 bits. Green Fox was in, Greybearded Gamer was in, Neo, me, you better watch out. Okay, yes, and thank you very much to Yakobu, of course, as always, for co-hosting. Very much good fun, etc. All those words in a sentence that makes sense.
Very much appreciated.
Very much, that whiskey, very much, don't open it, there's been a change of plan. Brilliant. And just Jack dressed as Hitler. Brilliant. Finishing on a note, finishing on a good note, or indeed a note of Hitler, that is the end of the stream, so goodbye everybody, good night, and goodbye.
Goodbye.
And stream, and...